has the basic idea that if someone's hungry, you should be able to give them food. And that's what, you know, this movement, these people are talking about is, you know, they just want to be able to give food to people that are hungry. So, you know, that's why I'm talking about this in this, this little video. You know, it's important to know whether you're in Houston, Texas, whether you're in another state. A lot of the major states and the major cities, there's a push to make it illegal to give food to the homeless. And it's just such a sad and mean-spirited law. And for example, there's a guy in Houston, his name is Jay Hamburger. And what he does is he boils eggs, and he gives boiled eggs to homeless. He's been doing it for years, for decades really. And the reason he does it is he just doesn't want these people to starve. It's humanitarian. It's not about being any type of, you know, Republican, Democrat, Libertarian. All it is about just not letting somebody starve. And it breaks my heart so much that, you know, this has become illegal. I mean, all these people want to do is just give food to somebody that's hungry. That's all they want to do. They don't want money for it. And the fact that the city has made it illegal, the city of Houston has made it a crime, a criminal act, to give food to the homeless, give food to someone hungry. And, you know, during Christmas, you know, it's illegal to do that. In fact, I have this case that I took where the city, what they did is this woman, she was giving food to homeless on Christmas Eve. They were starving. She wanted to give food to people, give them warm blankets. And in the grand scheme of things, yeah, it doesn't help much, but at least it helps that person that you see at the time. It kind of, it reminds me of the story, like the story of a starfish, where this boy is along the sea, and he's picking up these starfish, and he's just throwing them in. And someone's asking, why are you doing that? The reason he says he's doing it is because I'm helping this starfish right here. It might not matter to everybody else, but it matters to the starfish. You know, I'm talking about that because, like with my client, you know, where we're suing the city over, at least it mattered. The reason she gave food to those starving people on Christmas Eve is because it mattered to them. And in the grand scheme, yeah, it might not help everybody, but it helped the person then. And the whole thing that the city of Houston's pushing is this whole meaningful change, not spare change, but you need everything. And there's just not enough money to help all these starving people that exist. And some people don't even want to be helped. I mean, they want food, but not much more than that. They don't want to be rehabilitated. I mean, to be fair, our society is pretty crazy. And I can respect that they just don't want to, you know, take part in that. I can respect that. But I mean, I just don't see why they feel just the need to make it criminal to give somebody food. I mean, I can see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people money. I understand that. They might go spend it on drugs. Fine. I could see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people other things. And I guess I could say should be giving people, you know, stuff. But you should be able to give people clothing. It's in the Bible, for crying out loud. It's a humanitarian act. It's not even anything. It's just sad. And I can't believe why the current mayor and the previous mayor, they felt the need to make it a crime, to make it a criminal act to give food to the poor. I mean, the only way this is ever going to be changed is if really they're publicly shamed and that everybody knows that this law exists and everybody knows that, you know, the politicians don't want to change it. Whether they're Democrat, whether they're Republican, whether they're independent. And the whole reason they don't want to change it is how this law is really being used is it's pushing out, you know, poor people from areas that they want to gentrify. And I'm not saying I'm against gentrification. I'm not saying I'm for it. I'm just saying they're using it kind of like starving out animals. That's probably how they see it, is starving out animals from different areas. And, you know, downtown, there'll be a lot of, you know, homeless people that'll be downtown because there's natural shelter with, you know, buildings and bridges and what have you. And also there's, you know, there's different organizations, different people that just go downtown and feed people, which they should be able to. So I think what's going on is the city doesn't want, it's trying to push all these people, all these homeless people away from downtown, away from areas where developers are pouring, you know, hundreds and millions of dollars, probably tens of millions of dollars into the pockets of politicians. And these are, you know, Democrat politicians, Republican politicians, just any politician. They're, you know, throwing money into their campaign contributions. They're just, they're filling up their tank, filling up their political, building their political capital. And in return, politicians are making it illegal to give food to the homeless. I really think that's the reason. There could be other reasons, maybe, you know, maybe Star of Hope, maybe wherever those organizations are, that get federal funding, that get contributions, that are contribution-based. You know, they use their money, they use some of their money, they don't use all of it. In reality, it's kind of sad if you start looking at it. The majority of the money they get goes to their executives, and they're making like hundreds, $200,000, $300,000, $400,000 a year. And they're supposed to be out there actually helping people. So the city will make these laws to actually stop individuals from going out and giving food. But you know what? While they're doing that, since they're hindering it, instead they'll encourage people just to donate to, you know, the Red Cross or all these different organizations, Star of Hope, which in all reality they just spend just pennies of the dollars that they collect in actually helping people. I think that's just, it's just wrong. It's morally wrong. If you're a Christian, it's, you know, it's all sorts of wrong. If you're just a human, it's wrong. It's bad, bad energy, bad spirited. And we can't let this type of law push. We can't let this type of law continue. It's so, so sad, especially during the holiday season. I mean, during Christmas, you want it to be, you want someone to get a $2,000 fine, a $2,000 fine for giving food to the homeless. That's what you could get in the city of Houston. Imagine that. If you're just at your house, you feel bad, so you go make a ham sandwich and you give it to the poor because you just feel bad, and you get tacked with a $2,000 fine. That's a lot of money. If you can't pay it, you go sit in jail. We're just giving someone food? Really? Oh my goodness. This is our country. I mean, this was a law that was pushed under Denise Parker in the city of Houston, who's supposed to be, you know, a liberal progressive. And it's so mean. I just don't see how it's not a mean-spirited law. It's not just a bad energy law. You're trying to, when you're elected, you're supposed to be helping people. At least helping the least fortunate, the people that this law could have killed people if you think about it. How many times has someone been hungry and they haven't been able to get something? I mean, in France, they're pushing these laws where it requires, instead of throwing your food away, you give it to the homeless. I think that's nice. I think Houston should explore these type of laws like that. But it's just inhumanitarian. I mean, what's the purpose behind a law that makes it a criminal act to give food? So what I'm asking you do is just retweet this, you know, share it, what have you. Just let people know that these laws exist. The first thing is people got to realize that there's a problem. People don't realize there's a problem. They're too busy living their own lives, which, don't get me wrong, it's hard to live your own lives. If you have kids, I've got kids. They're exhausting. They beat me down all the time. If you're married, you know, you got to deal with that. But just take a second and share, you know, this video, share. Let people know that it's criminal, that it is a Class C misdemeanor. You could go to jail if you don't pay a $2,000 fine. $2,000 for giving food to the homeless. That's just wrong. I think we all can agree with that. At the bare minimum, we all can agree with that. So please, retweet it, you know, share it, what have you. Post it on your social media. Let people know that it shouldn't be illegal to feed the homeless. And please help me gather, you know, signatures for the petition.
A local pastor is fed up, and he's challenging the Houston homeless feeding ordinance.
And the city requires you to get a permit if you are going to share food. He can't get a permit because he doesn't know where he's going to share food.
Philip Paul Bryan regularly keeps cans of tuna and water bottles in his car to hand out to homeless people. But under the current city ordinance, he's breaking the law. His attorney says Bryan does this because his faith teaches him to help the less fortunate.
This law that's in place, it's a mean-spirited law. It's against, charity. It's against kindness. It's against doing the right thing.
Eric Dick says they plan to fight this till the mayor and city officials overturn what some believe is a misguided ordinance.
Feeding rocks. It should not be a crime to feed the homeless. Feeding rocks. A good Samaritan shouldn't be punished for acts of kindness. Feeding rocks. Because it's more of a crime to turn your back on a starving person. Feeding rocks. You shouldn't go to jail for sharing food. Feeding rocks. Can't in good conscience let a hungry person starve. Feeding rocks. Help us legalize charity. Go online and sign the petition. www.feeding.rocks. Feeding rocks. So what happened is in 2012, the city of Houston made it criminal to give food to the homeless. This is just, it's a crazy law. This has been going on in other cities. It's not just, it's all the major cities this has been going on. It's been going on in Florida. And in Florida, this elderly man has been put in jail for, oddly enough, feeding the homeless. It's just absolutely insane. I mean, you got to keep in mind that every type of religion, whether it's Christianity, whether it's Hinduism, whatever it is, it all has the basic idea that if someone's hungry, you should be able to give them food. And that's what, this movement, these people are talking about is, they just want to be able to give food to people that are hungry. So that's why I'm talking about this in this little video. It's important to know whether you're in Houston, Texas, whether you're in another state. A lot of the major states and the major cities, there's a push to make it illegal to give food to the homeless. And it's just such a sad and mean-spirited law. And for example, there's a guy in Houston, his name is Jay Hamburger. And what he does is he boils eggs. And he gives boiled eggs to homeless. He's been doing it for years, for decades, really. And the reason he does it is he just doesn't want these people to starve. It's humanitarian. It's not about being any type of, Republican, Democrat, Libertarian. All it is about just not letting somebody starve. And it breaks my heart so much that, this has become illegal. I mean, all these people want to do is just give food to somebody that's hungry. That's all they want to do. They don't want money for it. And the fact that the city has made it illegal, the city of Houston has made it a crime, a criminal act, to give food to the homeless, give food to someone hungry. And, during Christmas, it's illegal to do that. In fact, I have this case that I took where the city, what they did is this woman, she was giving food to homeless on Christmas Eve. They were starving. She wanted to give food to people, give them warm blankets. And in the grand scheme of things, yeah, it doesn't help much, but at least it helps that person that you see at the time. It reminds me of the story, like the story of a starfish, where this boy is along the sea, and he's picking up these starfish, and he's just throwing them in. And someone's asking, why are you doing that? The reason he says he's doing it is because I'm helping this starfish right here. It might not matter to everybody else, but it matters to the starfish. I'm talking about that because, like with my client, where we're suing the city over, at least it mattered. The reason she gave food to those starving people on Christmas Eve is because it mattered to them. And in the grand scheme, yeah, it might not help everybody, but it helped the person then. I mean, the whole thing that the city of Houston's pushing is this whole meaningful change, not spare change, but you need everything. And there's just not enough money to help all these starving people that exist. And some people don't even want to be helped. I mean, they want food, but not much more than that. They don't want to be rehabilitated. I mean, to be fair, our society is pretty crazy. And I can respect that they just don't want to, you know, take part in that. I can respect that. But I mean, I just don't see why they feel just the need to make it criminal to give somebody food. I mean, I can see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people money. I understand that. They might go spend it on drugs. Fine. I could see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people other things. And I guess I could say you shouldn't be giving people, you know, stuff. But you should be able to give people clothing. And it's in the Bible, for crying out loud. It's a humanitarian act. It's not even anything. It's just sad. And I can't believe why the current mayor and the previous mayor, they felt the need to make it a crime, to make it a criminal act to give food to the poor. I mean, the only way this is ever going to be changed is if really they're publicly shamed and that everybody knows that this law exists and everybody knows that, you know, the politicians don't want to change it. Whether they're Democrat, whether they're Republican, whether they're independent. And the whole reason they don't want to change it is how this law is really being used, is it's pushing out poor people from areas that they want to gentrify. And I'm not saying I'm against gentrification. I'm not saying I'm for it. I'm just saying they're using it kind of like starving out animals. That's probably how they see it, is starving out animals from different areas. And, you know, downtown, there'll be a lot of, you know, homeless people that'll be downtown because there's natural shelter with, you know, buildings and bridges and what have you. And also there's, there's different organizations, different people that just go downtown and feed people, which they should be able to. So I think what's going on is the city doesn't want, it's trying to push all these people, all these homeless people away from downtown, away from areas where developers are pouring, you know, hundreds and millions of dollars, probably tens of millions of dollars into the pockets of politicians. And these are, you know, Democrat politicians, Republican politicians, just any politician. They're, you know, throwing money into their campaign contributions. They're filling up their tank, filling up their political, building their political capital. And in return, politicians are making it illegal to give food to the homeless. I really think that's the reason. There could be other reasons, maybe Star of Hope, maybe wherever those organizations are, that get federal funding, they get contributions that are contribution-based. They use their money, they use some of their money, they don't use all of it. In reality, it's kind of sad if you start looking at it. The majority of the money they get goes to their executives, and they're making like hundreds of $200,000-$400,000 a year. They're supposed to be out there actually helping people. So the city will make these laws to actually stop individuals from going out and giving food. While they're doing that, since they're hindering it, instead they'll encourage people just to donate to, you know, the Red Cross or all these different organizations, Star of Hope, which in all reality they just spend just pennies of the dollars that they collect in actually helping people. I think that's just wrong. It's morally wrong. If you're a Christian, it's all sorts of wrong. If you're just a human, it's wrong. It's bad energy, bad spirited. And we can't let this type of law push. We can't let this type of law continue. It's so sad, especially during the holiday season. I mean, during Christmas, you want someone to get a $2,000 fine, $2,000 fine for giving food to the homeless. That's what you could get in the city of Houston. Imagine that. If you're just at your house, you feel bad, so you go make a ham sandwich and you give it to the poor because you just feel bad, and you get tacked with a $2,000 fine. That's a lot of money. If you can't pay it, you go sit in jail for just giving someone food. Really? Oh my goodness, this is our country. This was a law that was pushed underneath Parker in the city of Houston, who's supposed to be, you know, a liberal progressive. And it's just, it's so mean. I just don't see how it's not a mean-spirited law. It's not just a bad energy law. You're trying to, when you're elected, you're supposed to be helping people. At least helping the least fortunate, the people that this law could have killed people if you think about it. How many times has someone been hungry and hadn't been able to get something? I mean, in France, they're pushing these laws where it requires, instead of throwing your food away, you give it to the homeless. I think that's nice. I think Houston should explore these type of laws like that. But it's just inhumanitarian. I mean, what's the purpose behind a law that makes it a criminal act to give food? So what I'm asking you to do is just retweet this, you know, share it, what have you. Just let people know that these laws exist. The first thing is people got to realize that there's a problem. People don't realize there's a problem. They're too busy living their own lives, which, don't get me wrong, it's hard to live your own lives. If you have kids, I've got kids. They're exhausting. They beat me down all the time. If you're married, you know, you got to deal with that. But just take a second and share. You know, this video, share. Let people know that it's criminal, that it is a Class C misdemeanor. You could go to jail if you don't pay a $2,000 fine. $2,000 for giving food to the homeless. That's just wrong. I think we all can agree with that. At the bare minimum, we all can agree with that. So please, retweet it, you know, share it, what have you. Post it on your social media. Let people know that it shouldn't be illegal to feed the homeless. And please help me gather, you know, signatures for the petition.
Feeding Rocks. It should not be a crime to feed the homeless. Feeding Rocks. A good Samaritan shouldn't be punished for acts of kindness. Feeding Rocks. Because it's more of a crime to turn your back on a starving person. Feeding Rocks. You shouldn't go to jail for sharing food. Feeding Rocks. Can't in good conscience let a hungry person starve. Feeding Rocks. Help us legalize charity. Go online and sign the petition. www.feeding.rocks. Feeding Rocks.
A Houstonian claiming his religious freedom is being denied might soon see his lawsuit against the city dismissed.
And it appeared that Judge Kyle Carter was thinking about dismissing the case, saying that Philip doesn't have standing.
Philip Paul Bryant filed a lawsuit in 2017 claiming his religious rights to charitable giving were being infringed upon by a 2012 Houston Feeding the Homeless ordinance. In the city of Houston, you can give 5 homeless people a sandwich, but that 6th sandwich, that's the one that will cost you.
Could be fined $500 to $2,000, or you could even take the risk with going to jail.
According to his attorney, Eric Dick, Bryant's case may not find a home in Harris County Civil Court.
They're saying that my client, he waited over a year to file a lawsuit since he found out about the law. If people just found out about the law, and they want to sue the city for this illegal act, I'm happy to represent them for free. I think that it's a mean world whenever acts of charity are criminal.
To be fair, the ordinance doesn't outright ban the giving of food to the homeless. It just creates a lot of hurdles to jump through to do it lawfully.
My children are a big deal in this, and teaching them how to give to the community. If they want to make 10 sack lunches and go hand them around downtown Houston, I shouldn't have to go to my government office in order to obtain permission just to give those sandwiches.
So what happened is in 2012, the city of Houston made it criminal to give food to the homeless. And this is just, it's a crazy law. This has been going on in other cities. It's not just, it's all the major cities this has been going on. It's been going on in Florida. And in Florida, this elderly man has been put in jail for, oddly enough, feeding the homeless. It's just absolutely insane. I mean, you got to keep in mind that every type of religion, whether it's Christianity, whether it's Hinduism, whatever it is, it all has the basic idea that if someone's hungry, you should be able to give them food. And that's what, you know, this movement, these people are talking about is, you know, they just want to be able to give food to people that are hungry. So, you know, that's why I'm talking about this in this, this little video. You know, it's important to know whether you're in Houston, Texas, whether you're in another state. A lot of the major states and the major cities, there's a push to make it illegal to give food to the homeless. And it's just such a sad and mean-spirited law. And for example, there's a guy in Houston. His name is Jay Hamburger. And what he does is he boils eggs. And he gives boiled eggs to homeless. He's been doing it for years, for decades, really. And the reason he does it is he just doesn't want these people to starve. It's humanitarian. It's not about being any type of, you know, Republican, Democrat, Libertarian. All it is about just not letting somebody starve. And it breaks my heart so much that, you know, this has become illegal. I mean, all these people want to do is just give food to somebody that's hungry. That's all they want to do. They don't want money for it. And the fact that the city has made it illegal, the city of Houston has made it a crime, a criminal act, to give food to the homeless, give food to someone hungry. And, you know, during Christmas, you know, it's illegal to do that. In fact, I have this case that I took where the city, what they did is this woman, she was giving food to homeless on Christmas Eve. They were starving. She wanted to give food to people, give them warm blankets. And in the grand scheme of things, yeah, it doesn't help much, but at least it helps that person that you see at the time. It kind of, it reminds me of the story, like the story of a starfish, where this boy is along the sea, and he's picking up these starfish, and he's just throwing them in. And someone's asking, why are you doing that? The reason he says he's doing it is because I'm helping this starfish right here. It might not matter to everybody else, but it matters to the starfish. You know, I'm talking about that because, like with my client, you know, where we're suing the city over, at least it mattered. The reason she gave food to those starving people on Christmas Eve is because it mattered to them. And in the grand scheme, yeah, it might not help everybody, but it helped the person then. And the whole thing that the city of Houston's pushing is this whole meaningful change, not spare change, but you need everything. And there's just not enough money to help all these starving people that exist. And some people don't even want to be helped. I mean, they want food, but not much more than that. They don't want to be rehabilitated. I mean, to be fair, our society is pretty crazy. And I can respect that they just don't want to, you know, take part in that. I can respect that. But I mean, I just don't see why they feel just the need to make it criminal to give somebody food. I mean, I can see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people money. I understand that. They might go spend it on drugs. Fine. I could see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people other things. And I guess I could say should be giving people, you know, stuff. But you should be able to give people clothing. And it's in the Bible, for crying out loud. It's a humanitarian act. It's not even anything. It's just sad. I can't believe why the current mayor and the previous mayor, they felt the need to make it a crime, to make it a criminal act to give food to the poor. I mean, the only way and this is ever going to be changed is if really they're publicly shamed and that everybody knows that this law exists and everybody knows that, you know, the politicians don't want to change it. Whether they're Democrat, whether they're Republican, whether they're independent. And the whole reason they don't want to change it is how this law is really being used is it's pushing out you know, poor people from areas that they want to gentrify. And I'm not saying I'm against gentrification. I'm not saying I'm for it. I'm just saying they're using it kind of like starving out animals. That's probably how they see it, is starving out animals from different areas. And, you know, downtown, there'll be a lot of, you know, homeless people that'll be downtown because there's natural shelter with, you know, buildings and bridges and what have you. And also there's, you know, there's different organizations, different people that just go downtown and feed people, which they should be able to. So what I think what's going on is the city doesn't want, it's trying to push all these people, all these homeless people away from downtown, away from areas where developers are pouring, you know, hundreds and millions of dollars, probably tens of millions of dollars into the pockets of politicians. And these are, you know, Democrat politicians, Republican politicians, just any politician. They're, you know, throwing money into their campaign contributions. They're just, they're filling up their tank, filling up their political, building their political capital. And in return, politicians are making it illegal to give food to the homeless. I really think that's the reason. There could be other reasons, maybe, you know, maybe Star of Hope, maybe wherever those organizations are, that get federal funding. They get contributions that are contribution-based. You know, they use their money. They use some of their money. They don't use all of it. In reality, it's kind of sad if you start looking at it. The majority of the money they get goes to their executives, and they're making like hundreds, $200,000, $300,000, $400,000 a year. And they're supposed to be out there actually helping people. So the city will make these laws to actually stop individuals from going out and giving food, but you know what? While they're doing that, since they're hindering it, instead they'll encourage people just to donate to, you know, the Red Cross or all these different organizations, Star of Hope, which in all reality they just spend just pennies of the dollars that they collect in actually helping people. I think that's just, it's just wrong. It's morally wrong. If you're a Christian, it's, you know, it's all sorts of wrong. If you're just a human, it's wrong. It's bad, bad energy, bad spirited. And we can't let this type of law push. We can't let this type of law continue. It's so, so sad, especially during the holiday season. I mean, during Christmas, you want it to be, you want someone to get a $2,000 fine, a $2,000 fine for giving food to the homeless. That's what you could get in the city of Houston. Imagine that. If you're just at your house, you feel bad, so you go make a ham sandwich and you give it to the poor because you just feel bad, and you get tacked with a $2,000 fine. That's a lot of money. If you can't pay it, you go sit in jail for just giving someone food? Really? Oh my goodness. This is our country. I mean, this was a law that was pushed under Denise Parker in the city of Houston, who's supposed to be, you know, a liberal progressive. And it's just, it's so mean. I just don't see how it's not a mean-spirited law. It's not just a bad energy law. You're trying, when you're elected, you're supposed to be helping people. At least helping the least fortunate, the people that this law could have killed people if you think about it. How many times has someone been hungry and hadn't been able to get something? I mean, in France, they're pushing these laws where it requires, you know, instead of throwing your food away, you give it to the homeless. I think that's nice. I think Houston should explore these type of laws like that. But it's just inhumanitarian. I mean, what's the purpose behind a law that makes it a criminal act to give food? So what I'm asking you do is just retweet this, you know, share it, what have you. Just let people know that these laws exist. The first thing is people got to realize that there's a problem. People don't realize there's a problem. They're too busy living their own lives, which, don't get me wrong, it's hard to live your own lives. If you have kids, I've got kids. They're exhausting. They beat me down all the time. If you're married, you know, you got to deal with that. But just take a second and share. You know, this video, share. Let people know that it's criminal, that it is a Class C misdemeanor. You could go to jail if you don't pay a $2,000 fine. $2,000 for giving food to the homeless. That's just wrong. I think we all can agree with that. At the bare minimum, we all can agree with that. So please, retweet it, you know, share it, what have you. Post it on your social media. Let people know that it shouldn't be illegal to feed the homeless. And please help me gather, you know, signatures for the petition.
A Houston man tonight is taking on the city of Houston. He is suing, saying he has the constitutional right to feed the homeless this Thanksgiving and any other day that he chooses.
Fox 26's Domalee Keith is live at Houston City Hall with more details on this. Domalee?
Yeah, you may remember the charitable feeding ban went into effect a few years ago, making it illegal to feed the homeless. Well, Philip Paul Bryant says it shouldn't be against the law to give food to someone in need. He says it should be the other way around, a crime not to give.
Of just trying to make sure a fellow human doesn't starve.
It sounds simple enough.
We aren't asking for anything else than to be able to give food to those that are less fortunate. Please let us do it.
Houston City Council members say they passed the charitable feeding ban to ensure homeless people receive food prepared under health code regulations, and so those in need will turn to an organization to eat, so they will receive other resources, services, and shelter as well.
Many of them take probably no more than 150 people. How many homeless are there? You cannot fit all the homeless into the shelters.
We pursued this lawsuit because we felt the city was trying to disinfringe not only on the less fortunate, but also trying to discourage good people, good Samaritans, from doing the right thing.
It's Thanksgiving, and it's the whole purpose of this holiday is to share food and eat. Let us practice our religion. Let us follow our faith. That's all we're asking.
Someone doesn't give them food, they won't have food to eat that night.
Brian says a number of groups wanting to set up outdoors and feed the homeless this Thanksgiving are discouraged for fear of being punished by the police.
There's going to be a lot of people who are on that border of saying, yeah, do we feed them, do we not feed them, do we want to go to jail, do we want to get a ticket?
Now, those who want to gather and feed the homeless have to first get permission from the city. And depending on where you plan to set up, you'll have to get permission from the property owner as well. There is a $500 fine for violating the ban, and you could go to jail if you don't pay that fine. We're live in downtown Houston. I'm Domalee Keith, Fox 26 News.
Feeding Rocks. It should not be a crime to feed the homeless. Feeding Rocks. A good Samaritan shouldn't be punished for acts of kindness. Feeding Rocks. Because it's more of a crime to turn your back on a starving person. Feeding Rocks. You shouldn't go to jail for sharing food. Feeding Rocks. You can't in good conscience let a hungry person starve. Feeding Rocks. Help us legalize charity. Go online and sign the petition. www.feeding.rocks. Feeding Rocks.
So what happened is in 2012, the city of Houston made it criminal to give food to the homeless. This is just, it's a crazy law. This has been going on in other cities. It's not just, it's all the major cities this has been going on. It's been going on in Florida. And in Florida, this elderly man has been put in jail for, oddly enough, feeding the homeless. It's just absolutely insane. I mean, you got to keep in mind that every type of religion, whether it's Christianity, whether it's Hinduism, whatever it is, it all has the basic idea that if someone's hungry, you should be able to give them food. And that's what, you know, this movement, these people are talking about is, you know, they just want to be able to give food to people that are hungry. So, you know, that's why I'm talking about this in this little video. You know, it's important to know whether you're in Houston, Texas, whether you're in another state. A lot of the major states and the major cities, there's a push to make it illegal to give food to the homeless. And it's just such a sad and mean-spirited law. And for example, there's a guy in Houston, his name is Jay Hamburger, and what he does is he boils eggs. And he gives boiled eggs to homeless. He's been doing it for years, for decades, really. And the reason he does it is he just doesn't want these people to starve. It's humanitarian. It's not about being any type of, you know, Republican, Democrat, Libertarian. All it is is about just not letting somebody starve. And it breaks my heart so much that, you know, this has become illegal. I mean, all these people want to do is just give food to somebody that's hungry. That's all they want to do. They don't want money for it. And the fact that the city has made it illegal, the city of Houston has made it a crime, a criminal act, to give food to the homeless, give food to someone hungry. And, you know, during Christmas, it's illegal to do that. In fact, I have this case that I took where the city, what they did is this woman, she was giving food to homeless on Christmas Eve. They were starving. She wanted to give food to people, give them warm blankets. And in the grand scheme of things, yeah, it doesn't help much, but at least it helps that person that you see at the time. It reminds me of the story, like the story of a starfish, where this boy is along the sea, and he's picking up these starfish, and he's just throwing them in. And someone's asking, why are you doing that? The reason he says he's doing it is because I'm helping this starfish right here. It might not matter to everybody else, but it matters to the starfish. You know, I'm talking about that because, like with my client, you know, where we're suing the city over, at least it mattered. The reason she gave food to those starving people on Christmas Eve is because it mattered to them. And in the grand scheme, yeah, it might not help everybody, but it helped the person then. And the whole thing that the city of Houston's pushing is this whole meaningful change, not spare change, but you need everything. And there's just not enough money to help all these starving people that exist. And some people don't even want to be helped. I mean, they want food, but not much more than that. They don't want to be rehabilitated. I mean, to be fair, our society is pretty crazy. And I can respect that they just don't want to, you know, take part in that. I can respect that. But I just don't see why they feel just the need to make it criminal to give somebody food. I mean, I could see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people money. I understand that. They might go spend it on drugs. Fine. I could see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people other things. And I guess I could say should be giving people, you know, stuff. But you should be able to give people clothing. And it's in the Bible, for crying out loud. It's a humanitarian act. It's not even anything. It's just sad. And I can't believe why the current mayor and the previous mayor, they felt the need to make it a crime, to make it a criminal act to give food to the poor. I mean, the only way this is ever going to be changed is if really they're publicly shamed and that everybody knows that this law exists, and everybody knows that, you know, the politicians don't want to change it, whether they're Democrat, whether they're Republican, whether they're independent. And the whole reason they don't want to change it is how this law is really being used, is it's pushing out, poor people from areas that they want to gentrify. And I'm not saying I'm against gentrification. I'm not saying I'm for it. I'm just saying they're using it kind of like starving out animals. That's probably how they see it, is starving out animals from different areas. And, you know, downtown, there'll be a lot of, you know, homeless people that'll be downtown because there's natural shelter with, you know, buildings and bridges and what have you. And also there's, there's different organizations, different people that just go downtown and feed people, which they should be able to. So what I think what's going on is the city doesn't want, it's trying to push all these people, all these homeless people away from downtown, away from areas where developers are pouring, you know, hundreds and millions of dollars, probably tens of millions of dollars into the pockets of politicians. And these are, you know, Democrat politicians, Republican politicians, just any politician. They're, you know, throwing money into their campaign contributions. They're filling up their tank, filling up their political, building their political capital. And in return, politicians are making it illegal to give food to the homeless. I really think that's the reason. There could be other reasons, maybe Star of Hope, maybe wherever those organizations are, that get federal funding, that get contributions that are contribution-based. They use some of their money. They don't use all of it. And reality, it's kind of sad if you start looking at it. The majority of the money they get goes to their executives, and they're making like hundreds, $200,000, $300,000, $400,000 a year. And they're supposed to be out there actually helping people. So the city will make these laws to actually stop individuals from going out and giving food. But you know what? While they're doing that, since they're hindering it, instead they'll encourage people just to donate to, you know, the Red Cross or all these different organizations, Star of Hope, which in all reality they just spend just pennies of the dollars that they collect in actually helping people. I think that's just, it's just wrong. It's morally wrong. If you're a Christian, it's, you know, it's all sorts of wrong. If you're just a human, it's wrong. It's bad, bad energy, bad spirited. And we can't let this type of law push. We can't let this type of law continue. It's so, so sad, especially during the holiday season. I mean, during Christmas, you want it to be, you want someone to get a $2,000 fine, a $2,000 fine for giving food to the homeless. That's what you could get in the city of Houston. Imagine that. If you're just at your house, you feel bad, so you go make a ham sandwich and you give it to the poor because you just feel bad, and you get tacked with a $2,000 fine. That's a lot of money. If you can't pay it, you go sit in jail for just giving someone food? Really? Oh my goodness. This is our country. I mean, this was a law that was pushed under Denise Parker in the city of Houston, who's supposed to be, you know, a liberal progressive. And it's so mean. I just don't see how it's not a mean-spirited law. It's not just a bad energy law. You're trying to, when you're elected, you're supposed to be helping people. At least helping the least fortunate, the people that this law could have killed people if you think about it. How many times has someone been hungry and hadn't been able to get something? I mean, in France, they're pushing these laws where it requires, instead of throwing your food away, you give it to the homeless. I think that's nice. I think Houston should explore these type of laws like that. But it's just inhumanitarian. I mean, what's the purpose behind a law that makes it a criminal act to give food? So what I'm asking you do is just retweet this, you know, share it, what have you. Just let people know that these laws exist. The first thing is people got to realize that there's a problem. People don't realize there's a problem. They're too busy living their own lives, which, don't get me wrong, it's hard to live your own lives. If you have kids, I've got kids. They're exhausting. They beat me down all the time. If you're married, you know, you got to deal with that. But just take a second and share. You know, this video, share. Let people know that it's criminal, that it is a Class C misdemeanor. You could go to jail if you don't pay a $2,000 fine. $2,000 for giving food to the homeless. That's just wrong. I think we all can agree with that. At the bare minimum, we all can agree with that. So please, retweet it, you know, share it, what have you. Post it on your social media. Let people know that it shouldn't be illegal to feed the homeless. And please help me gather, you know, signatures for the petition.
Feeding Rocks. It should not be a crime to feed the homeless. Feeding Rocks. A good Samaritan shouldn't be punished for acts of kindness. Feeding Rocks. Because it's more of a crime to turn your back on a starving person. Feeding Rocks. You shouldn't go to jail for sharing food. Feeding Rocks. You can't in good conscience let a hungry person starve. Feeding Rocks. Help us legalize charity. Go online and sign the petition. www.feeding.rocks. Feeding Rocks.
Breaking the law, one meal at a time, feeding the homeless.
It is morally wrong to make it a crime to give food.
A Houston man who feeds the homeless because of his faith is suing the city, challenging the established charitable feeding ban. The often debated ordinance has banned sharing food in public groups of more than five people without city permission since 2012.
The city says you can give food to five people, not six. What are you supposed to tell the sixth person? I met my quota today.
The city wants to dismiss Philip Paul Bryant's lawsuit.
That's a crime? What does this world come to? It's a sad day whenever trying to prevent a fellow human from starving is a crime.
The city says the ordinance aims to curb trespassing and littering, both of which were already prohibited in the municipal code prior to the passing of the ordinance. While some Houstonians are in support of the lawsuit,
I really hope he wins his case, and I really hope they lift those sanctions so we can be able to give more to the needy.
So if you're willing to help more than 5 homeless people, you should be able to do that.
Some even challenge the city's support of their citizens.
The city isn't going to take care of their homeless people. That's their people. Somebody got to take care of them. So why can't we take care of them?
A question Houstonians will continue to ask as long as the ban remains.
Is in 2012, the city of Houston made it criminal to give food to the homeless. This is just, it's a crazy law. This has been going on in other cities. It's not just, it's all the major cities this has been going on. It's been going on in Florida. And in Florida, this elderly man has been put in jail for, oddly enough, feeding the homeless. It's just absolutely insane. I mean, you got to keep in mind that every type of religion, whether it's Christianity, whether it's Hinduism, whatever it is, it all has the basic idea that if someone's hungry, you should be able to give them food. And that's what, you know, this movement, these people are talking about is, you know, they just want to be able to give food to people that are hungry. So, you know, that's why I'm talking about this in this little video. You know, it's important to know whether you're in Houston, Texas, whether you're in another state. A lot of the major states and the major cities, there's a push to make it illegal to give food to the homeless. And it's just such a sad and mean-spirited law. And for example, there's a guy in Houston, his name is Jay Hamburger, and what he does is he boils eggs. And he gives boiled eggs to homeless. He's been doing it for years, for decades, really. And the reason he does it is he just doesn't want these people to starve. It's humanitarian. It's not about being any type of, you know, Republican, Democrat, Libertarian. All it is about just not letting somebody starve. And it breaks my heart so much that, you know, this has become illegal. I mean, all these people want to do is just give food to somebody that's hungry. That's all they want to do. They don't want money for it. And the fact that the city has made it illegal, the city of Houston has made it a crime, a criminal act, to give food to the homeless, give food to someone hungry. And, you know, during Christmas, you know, it's illegal to do that. In fact, I have this case that I took where the city, what they did is this woman, she was giving food to homeless on Christmas Eve. They were starving. She wanted to give food to people, give them warm blankets. And in the grand scheme of things, yeah, it doesn't help much, but at least it helps that person that you see at the time. It kind of, it reminds me of the story, like the story of a starfish, where this boy is along the sea, and he's picking up these starfish, and he's just throwing them in. And someone's asking, why are you doing that? The reason he says he's doing it is because I'm helping this starfish right here. It might not matter to everybody else, but it matters to the starfish. You know, I'm talking about that because, like with my client, you know, where we're suing the city over, at least it mattered. The reason she gave food to those starving people on Christmas Eve is because it mattered to them. And in the grand scheme, yeah, it might not help everybody, but it helped the person then. And the whole thing that the city of Houston's pushing is this whole meaningful change, not spare change, but you need everything. And there's just not enough money to help all these starving people that exist. And some people don't even want to be helped. I mean, they want food, but not much more than that. They don't want to be rehabilitated. I mean, to be fair, our society is pretty crazy. And I can respect that they just don't want to, you know, take part in that. I can respect that. But I just don't see why they feel just the need to to make it criminal to give somebody food. I mean, I could see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people money. I understand that. They might go spend it on drugs. Fine. I could see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people other things. And I guess I could say should be giving people, you know, stuff, but you should be able to give people clothing. And it's in the Bible, for crying out loud. It's a humanitarian act. It's not even anything. It's just sad. And I can't believe why the current mayor and the previous mayor, they felt the need to make it a crime, to make it a criminal act, to give food to the poor. I mean, the only way this is ever going to be changed is if really they're publicly shamed and that everybody knows that this law exists and everybody knows that, you know, the politicians don't want to change it, whether they're Democrat, whether they're Republican, whether they're independent. And the whole reason they don't want to change it is how this law is really being used is it's pushing out, poor people from areas that they want to gentrify. And I'm not saying I'm against gentrification. I'm not saying I'm for it. I'm just saying they're using it kind of like starving out animals. That's probably how they see it, is starving out animals from different areas. And, you know, downtown, there'll be a lot of, you know, homeless people that'll be downtown because there's natural shelter with, you know, buildings and bridges and what have you. And also there's, there's different organizations, different people that just go downtown and feed people, which they should be able to. So what I think what's going on is the city doesn't want, it's trying to push all these people, all these homeless people away from downtown, away from areas where developers are pouring, you know, hundreds and millions of dollars, probably tens of millions of dollars into the pockets of politicians. And these are, you know, Democrat politicians, Republican politicians, just any politician. They're, you know, throwing money into their campaign contributions. They're filling up their tank, filling up their political, building their political capital. And in return, politicians are making it illegal to give food to the homeless. I really think that's the reason. There could be other reasons, maybe Star of Hope, maybe wherever those organizations are, that get federal funding. They get contributions that are contribution-based. They use their money. They use some of their money. They don't use all of it. In reality, it's kind of sad if you start looking at it. The majority of the money they get goes to their executives, and they're making like hundreds, $200,000, $300,000, $400,000 a year. And they're supposed to be out there actually helping people. So the city will make these laws to actually stop individuals from going out and giving food, but you know what? While they're doing that, since they're hindering it, instead they'll encourage people just to donate to, you know, the Red Cross or all these different organizations, Star of Hope, which in all reality they just spend just pennies of the dollars that they collect in actually helping people. I think that's it's just wrong. It's morally wrong. If you're a Christian, it's all sorts of wrong. If you're just a human, it's wrong. It's bad, bad energy, bad spirited. And we can't let this type of law push. We can't let this type of law continue. It's so, so sad, especially during the holiday season. I mean, during Christmas, you want someone to get a $2,000 fine, a $2,000 fine for giving food to the homeless. That's what you could get in the city of Houston. Imagine that. If you're just at your house, you feel bad. So you go make a ham sandwich and you give it to the poor because you just feel bad, and you get tacked with a $2,000 fine. That's a lot of money. If you can't pay it, you go sit in jail for just giving someone food? Really? Oh my goodness. This is our country. I mean, this was a law that was pushed underneath Parker in the city of Houston, who's supposed to be, you know, a liberal progressive. And it's so mean. I just don't see how it's not a mean-spirited law. It's not just a bad energy law. You're trying to, when you're elected, you're supposed to be helping people. At least helping the least fortunate, the people that this law could have killed people if you think about it. How many times has someone been hungry and they haven't been able to get something? And in France, they're pushing these laws where it requires, you know, instead of throwing your food away, you give it to the homeless. I think that's nice. I think Houston should explore these type of laws like that. But it's just inhumanitarian. I mean, what's the purpose behind a law that makes it a criminal act to give food? So what I'm asking you do is just retweet this, you know, share it, what have you. Just let people know that these laws exist. The first thing is people got to realize that there's a problem. People don't realize there's a problem. They're too busy living their own lives, which, don't get me wrong, it's hard to live your own lives. If you have kids, I've got kids. They're exhausting. They beat me down all the time. If you're married, you know, you got to deal with that. But just take a second and share, you know, this, share, you know, this video, share, let people know that it's criminal, that it is a Class C misdemeanor. You could go to jail if you don't pay a $2,000 fine. $2,000 for giving food to the homeless. That's just wrong. I think we all can agree with that. At the bare minimum, we all can agree with that. So please, retweet it, you know, share it, what have you. Post it on your social media. Let people know that it shouldn't be illegal to feed the homeless. And please help me gather, you know, signatures for the petition.
A local pastor is fed up, and he's challenging the Houston Homeless Feeding Ordinance.
And the city requires you to get a permit if you are going to share food. He can't get a permit because he doesn't know where he's going to share food.
Philip Paul Bryan regularly keeps cans of tuna and water bottles in his car to hand out to homeless people. But under the current city ordinance, he's breaking the law. His attorney says Bryan does this because his faith teaches him to help the less fortunate.
This law that's in place, it's a mean-spirited law. It's against, you know, charity. It's against kindness. It's against doing the right thing.
Eric Dick says they plan to fight this till the mayor and city officials overturn what some believe is a misguided ordinance.
Feeding rocks. It should not be a crime to feed the homeless. Feeding rocks. A good Samaritan shouldn't be punished for acts of kindness. Feeding rocks. Because it's more of a crime to turn your back on a starving person. Feeding rocks. You shouldn't go to jail for sharing food. Feeding rocks. Can't in good conscience let a hungry person starve. Feeding rocks. Help us legalize charity. Go online and sign the petition. www.feeding.rocks. Feeding rocks.
So what happened is in 2012, the city of Houston made it criminal to give food to the homeless. And this is just, it's a crazy law. This has been going on in other cities. It's not just, it's all the major cities this has been going on. It's been going on in Florida. And in Florida, this elderly man has been put in jail for, oddly enough, feeding the homeless. It's just absolutely insane. I mean, you got to keep in mind that every type of religion, whether it's Christianity, whether it's Hinduism, whatever it is, it all has the basic idea that if someone's hungry, you should be able to give them food. And that's what, you know, this movement, these people are talking about, is, you know, they just want to be able to give food to people that are hungry. So, you know, that's why I'm talking about this in this little video. You know, it's important to know whether you're in Houston, Texas, whether you're in another state. A lot of the major states and the major cities, there's a push to make it illegal to give food to the homeless. And it's just such a sad and mean-spirited law. And for example, there's a guy in Houston, his name is Jay Hamburger. And what he does is he boils eggs. And he gives boiled eggs to homeless. He's been doing it for years, for decades, really. And the reason he does it is he just doesn't want these people to starve. It's humanitarian. It's not about being any type of, you know, Republican, Democrat, Libertarian. All it is about just not letting somebody starve. And it breaks my heart so much that, you know, this has become illegal. I mean, all these people want to do is just give food to somebody that's hungry. That's all they want to do. They don't want money for it. And the fact that the city has made it illegal, the city of Houston has made it a crime, a criminal act, to give food to the homeless, give food to someone hungry. And, you know, during Christmas, it's illegal to do that. In fact, I have this case that I took where the city, what they did is this woman, she was giving food to homeless on Christmas Eve. They were starving. She wanted to give food to people, give them warm blankets. And in the grand scheme of things, yeah, it doesn't help much, but at least it helps that person that you see at the time. It reminds me of the story, like the story of a starfish, where this boy is along the sea, and he's picking up these starfish, and he's just throwing them in. And someone's asking, why are you doing that? The reason he says he's doing it is because I'm helping this starfish right here. It might not matter to everybody else, but it matters to the starfish. You know, I'm talking about that because, like with my client, you know, where we're suing the city over, at least it mattered. The reason she gave food to those starving people on Christmas Eve is because it mattered to them. And in the grand scheme, yeah, it might not help everybody, but it helped the person then. And the whole thing that the city of Houston's pushing is this whole meaningful change, not spare change, but you need everything. And there's just not enough money to help all these starving people that exist. And some people don't even want to be helped. I mean, they want food, but not much more than that. They don't want to be rehabilitated. I mean, to be fair, our society is pretty crazy. And I can respect that they just don't want to, you know, take part in that. I can respect that. But I mean, I just don't see why they feel just the need to make it criminal to give somebody food. I mean, I can see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people money. I understand that. They might go spend it on drugs. Fine. I could see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people other things. And I guess I could say should be giving people, you know, stuff. But you should be able to give people clothing. And it's in the Bible. We're crying out loud. It's a humanitarian act. It's not even anything. It's just sad. I can't believe why the current mayor and the previous mayor, they felt the need to make it a crime, to make it a criminal act to give food to the poor. The only way this is ever going to be changed is if really they're publicly shamed and that everybody knows that this law exists and everybody knows that, you know, the politicians don't want to change it. Whether they're Democrat, whether they're Republican, whether they're independent. And the whole reason they don't want to change it is how this law is really being used, is it's pushing out poor people from areas that they want to gentrify. And I'm not saying I'm against gentrification. I'm not saying I'm for it. I'm just saying they're using it kind of like starving out animals. That's probably how they see it, is starving out animals from different areas. And, you know, downtown, there'll be a lot of, you know, homeless people that'll be downtown because there's natural shelter with, you know, buildings and bridges and what have you. And also there's, there's different organizations, different people that just go downtown and feed people, which they should be able to. So I think what's going on is the city doesn't want, it's trying to push all these people, all these homeless people away from downtown, away from areas where developers are pouring, you know, hundreds and millions of dollars, probably tens of millions of dollars into the pockets of politicians. And these are, you know, Democrat politicians, Republican politicians, just any politician. They're, you know, throwing money into their campaign contributions. They're filling up their tank, filling up their political, building their political capital. And in return, politicians are making it illegal to give food to the homeless. I really think that's the reason. There could be other reasons, maybe Star of Hope, maybe wherever those organizations are, that get federal funding, they get contributions that are contribution-based. They use their money, they use some of their money, they don't use all of it, and reality, it's kind of sad if you start looking at it. The majority of the money they get goes to their executives, and they're making like hundreds, $200,000, $300,000, $400,000 a year. And they're supposed to be out there actually helping people. So the city will make these laws to actually stop individuals from going out and giving food. But you know what? While they're doing that, since they're hindering it, instead they'll encourage people just to donate to, you know, the Red Cross or all these different organizations, Star of Hope, which in all reality they just spend just pennies of the dollars that they collect in actually helping people. I think that's it's just wrong. It's morally wrong. If you're a Christian, it's all sorts of wrong. If you're just a human, it's wrong. It's bad energy, bad spirited. And we can't let this type of law push. We can't let this type of law continue. It's so sad, especially during the holiday season. I mean, during Christmas, you want someone to get a $2,000 fine, a $2,000 fine for giving food to the homeless. That's what you could get in the city of Houston. Imagine that. If you're just at your house, you feel bad, so you go make a ham sandwich and you give it to the poor because you just feel bad, and you get tacked with a $2,000 fine. That's a lot of money. If you can't pay it, you go sit in jail for just giving someone food? Really? Oh my goodness. This is our country. I mean, this was a law that was pushed under Denise Parker in the city of Houston, who's supposed to be, you know, a liberal progressive. And it's so mean. I just don't see how it's not a mean-spirited law. It's not just a bad energy law. When you're elected, you're supposed to be helping people. At least helping the least fortunate, the people that this law could have killed people if you think about it. How many times has someone been hungry and hadn't been able to get something? I mean, in France, they're pushing these laws where it requires, instead of throwing your food away, you give it to the homeless. I think that's nice. I think Houston should explore these type of laws like that. But it's just inhumanitarian. I mean, what's the purpose behind a law that makes it a criminal act to give food? So what I'm asking you do is just retweet this, you know, share it, what have you. Just let people know that these laws exist. The first thing is people got to realize that there's a problem. People don't realize there's a problem. They're too busy living their own lives, which, don't get me wrong, it's hard to live your own lives. If you have kids, I've got kids. They're exhausting. They beat me down all the time. If you're married, you know, you got to deal with that. But just take a second and share. You know, this video, share. Let people know that it's criminal, that it is a Class C misdemeanor. You could go to jail if you don't pay a $2,000 fine. $2,000 for giving food to the homeless. That's just wrong. I think we all can agree with that. At the bare minimum, we all can agree with that. So please, retweet it, you know, share it, what have you. Post it on your social media. Let people know that it shouldn't be illegal to feed the homeless. And please help me gather, you know, signatures for the petition.
Feeding Rocks. It should not be a crime to feed the homeless. Feeding Rocks. A good Samaritan shouldn't be punished for acts of kindness. Feeding Rocks. Because it's more of a crime to turn your back on a starving person. Feeding Rocks. You shouldn't go to jail for sharing food. Feeding Rocks. Can't in good conscience let a hungry person starve. Feeding Rocks. Help us legalize charity. Go online and sign the petition. www.feeding.rocks. Feeding Rocks.
A Houstonian claiming his religious freedom is being denied might soon see his lawsuit against the city dismissed.
And it appeared that Judge Kyle Carter was thinking about dismissing the case, saying that Philip doesn't have standing.
Philip Paul Bryant filed a lawsuit in 2017 claiming his religious rights to charitable giving were being infringed upon by a 2012 Houston Feeding the Homeless ordinance. In the city of Houston, you can give 5 homeless people a sandwich, but that 6th sandwich That's the one that will cost you.
Could be fined $500 to $2,000, or you could even take the risk with going to jail.
According to his attorney, Eric Dick, Bryant's case may not find a home in Harris County Civil Court.
They're saying that my client, he waited over a year to file a lawsuit since he found out about the law. If people just found out about the law and they want to sue the city for this illegal act, I'm happy to represent them for free. I think that it's a mean world whenever acts of charity are criminal.
To be fair, the ordinance doesn't outright ban the giving of food to the homeless. It just creates a lot of hurdles to jump through to do it lawfully.
My children are a big deal in this, and teaching them how to give to the community. If they want to make 10 sack lunches and go hand them around downtown Houston, I shouldn't have to go to my government office in order to obtain permission just to give those sandwiches.
So what happened is in 2012, the city of Houston made it criminal to give food to the homeless. And this is just, it's a crazy law. This has been going on in other cities. It's not just, it's all the major cities this has been going on. It's been going on in Florida. And in Florida, this elderly man has been put in jail for, oddly enough, feeding the homeless. It's just absolutely insane. I mean, you got to keep in mind that every type of religion, whether it's Christianity, whether it's Hinduism, whatever it is, it all has the basic idea that if someone's hungry, you should be able to give them food. And that's what, you know, this movement, these people are talking about is, you know, they just want to be able to give food to people that are hungry. So, you know, that's why I'm talking about this in this little video. You know, it's important to know whether you're in Houston, Texas, whether you're in another state. A lot of the major states and the major cities, there's a push to make it illegal to give food to the homeless. And it's just such a sad and mean-spirited law. And for example, there's a guy in Houston, his name is Jay Hamburger, and what he does is he boils eggs. And he gives boiled eggs to homeless. He's been doing it for years, for decades, really. And the reason he does it is he just doesn't want these people to starve. It's humanitarian. It's not about being any type of, you know, Republican, Democrat, Libertarian. All it is about just not letting somebody starve. And it breaks my heart so much that, you know, this has become illegal. I mean, all these people want to do is just give food to somebody that's hungry. That's all they want to do. They don't want money for it. And the fact that the city has made it illegal, the city of Houston has made it a crime, a criminal act, to give food to the homeless, give food to someone hungry. And, you know, during Christmas, you know, it's illegal to do that. In fact, I have this case that I took where the city, what they did is this woman, she was giving food to homeless on Christmas Eve. They were starving. She wanted to give food to people, give them warm blankets. And in the grand scheme of things, yeah, it doesn't help much, but at least it helps that person that you see at the time. It reminds me of the story, like the story of starfish, where this boy is along the sea, and he's picking up these starfish, and he's just throwing them in. And someone's asking, why are you doing that? The reason he says he's doing it is because I'm helping this starfish right here. It might not matter to everybody else, but it matters to the starfish. You know, I'm talking about that because, like with my client, you know, where we're suing the city over, at least it mattered. The reason she gave food to those starving people on Christmas Eve is because it mattered to them. And in the grand scheme, yeah, it might not help everybody, but it helped the person then. And the whole thing that the city of Houston's pushing is this whole meaningful change, not spare change, but you need everything. And there's just not enough money to help all these starving people that exist. And some people don't even want to be helped. I mean, they want food, but not much more than that. They don't want to be rehabilitated. I mean, to be fair, our society is pretty crazy. And I can respect that they just don't want to, you know, take part in that. I can respect that. But I mean, I just don't see why they feel just the need to make it criminal to give somebody food. I mean, I can see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people money. I understand that. They might go spend it on drugs. Fine. I could see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people other things. And I guess I could say should be giving people, you know, stuff. But you should be able to give people clothing. And it's in the Bible, for crying out loud. It's a humanitarian act. It's not even anything. It's just sad. And I can't believe why the current mayor and the previous mayor, they felt the need to make it a crime, to make it a criminal act to give food to the poor. I mean, the only way this is ever going to be changed is if really they're publicly shamed and that everybody knows that this law exists and everybody knows that, you know, the politicians don't want to change it. Whether they're Democrat, whether they're Republican, whether they're independent. And the whole reason they don't want to change it is how this law is really being used, is it's pushing out poor people from areas that they want to gentrify. And I'm not saying I'm against gentrification. I'm not saying I'm for it. I'm just saying they're using it kind of like starving out animals. That's probably how they see it, is starving out animals from different areas. And, you know, downtown, there'll be a lot of, you know, homeless people that'll be downtown because there's natural shelter with, you know, buildings and bridges and what have you. And also there's, there's different organizations, different people that just go downtown and feed people, which they should be able to. So I think what's going on is the city it's trying to push all these people, all these homeless people away from downtown, away from areas where developers are pouring, you know, hundreds and millions of dollars, probably tens of millions of dollars into the pockets of politicians. And these are, you know, Democrat politicians, Republican politicians, just any politician. They're, you know, throwing money into their campaign contributions. They're filling up their tank, filling up their political, building their political capital. And in return, politicians are making it illegal to give food to the homeless. I really think that's the reason. There could be other reasons, maybe Star of Hope, maybe wherever those organizations are, that get federal funding, they get contributions that are contribution-based. They use their money, they use some of their money, they don't use all of it. In reality, it's kind of sad if you start looking at it. The majority of the money they get goes to their executives, and they're making like hundreds of $200,000-$400,000 a year, when they're supposed to be out there actually helping people. So the city will make these laws to actually stop individuals from going out and giving food. While they're doing that, since they're hindering it, instead they'll encourage people just to donate to, you know, the Red Cross or all these different organizations, Star of Hope, which in all reality they just spend just pennies of the dollars that they collect in actually helping people. I think that's it's just wrong. It's morally wrong. If you're a Christian, it's all sorts of wrong. If you're just a human, it's wrong. It's bad, bad energy, bad spirited. And we can't let this type of law push. We can't let this type of law continue. It's so, so sad, especially during the holiday season. I mean, during Christmas, you want someone to get a $2,000 fine, $1,000 fine for giving food to the homeless. That's what you could get in the city of Houston. Imagine that. If you're just at your house, you feel bad, so you go make a ham sandwich and you give it to the poor because you just feel bad, and you get tacked with a $2,000 fine. That's a lot of money. If you can't pay it, you go sit in jail for just giving someone food? Really? Oh my goodness. This is our country. I mean, this was a law that was pushed under Denise Parker in the city of Houston, who's supposed to be, you know, a liberal progressive. And it's so mean. I just don't see how it's not a mean-spirited law. It's not just a bad energy law. You're trying to, when you're elected, you're supposed to be helping people. At least helping the least fortunate, the people that this law could have killed people if you think about it. How many times has someone been hungry and hadn't been able to get something? I mean, in France, they're pushing these laws where it requires, instead of throwing your food away, you give it to the homeless. I think that's nice. I think Houston should explore these type of laws like that. But it's just inhumanitarian. I mean, what's the purpose behind a law that makes it a criminal act to give food? So what I'm asking you do is just retweet this, share it, what have you. Just let people know that these laws exist. The first thing is people got to realize that there's a problem. People don't realize there's a problem. They're too busy living their own lives, which, don't get me wrong, it's hard to live your own lives. If you have kids, I've got kids. They're exhausting. They beat me down all the time. If you're married, you got to deal with that. But just take a second and share. This video, share. Let people know that it's criminal, that it is a Class C misdemeanor. You could go to jail if you don't pay a $2,000 fine. $2,000 for giving food to the homeless. That's just wrong. I think we all can agree with that. At the bare minimum, we all can agree with that. So please, retweet it, share it, what have you. Post it on your social media. Let people know that it shouldn't be illegal to feed the homeless. And please help me gather, signatures for the petition.
A Houston man tonight is taking on the city of Houston. He is suing, saying he has the constitutional right to feed the homeless this Thanksgiving and any other day that he chooses.
Fox 26's Domalee Keith is live at Houston City Hall with more details on this. Domalee?
Yeah, you may remember the charitable feeding ban went into effect a few years ago, making it illegal to feed the homeless. Well, Philip Paul Bryant says it shouldn't be against the law to give food to someone in need. He says it should be the other way around, a crime not to give.
Of just trying to make sure a fellow human doesn't starve.
It sounds simple enough.
We aren't asking for anything else than to be able to give food to those that are less fortunate. Please let us do it.
Houston City Council members say they passed the charitable feeding ban to ensure homeless people receive food prepared under health code regulations, and so those in need will turn to an organization to eat, so they will receive other resources, services, and shelter as well.
Many of them take probably no more than 150 people. How many homeless are there? You cannot fit all the homeless into the shelters.
We pursued this lawsuit because we felt the city was trying to disinfringe not only on the less fortunate, but also trying to discourage good people, good Samaritans, from doing the right thing.
It's Thanksgiving. And it's the whole purpose of this holiday is to share food and eat. Let us practice our religion. Let us follow our faith. That's all we're asking.
Someone doesn't give them food, they won't have food to eat that night.
Brian says a number of groups wanting to set up outdoors and feed the homeless this Thanksgiving are discouraged for fear of being punished by the police.
There's going to be a lot of people who are on that border of saying, yeah, do we feed them, do we not feed them, do we want to go to jail, do we want to get a ticket?
Now, those who want to gather and feed the homeless have to first get permission from the city. And depending on where you plan to set up, you'll have to get permission from the property owner as well. There is a $500 fine for violating the ban, and you could go to jail if you don't pay that fine. We're live in downtown Houston. I'm Domalee Keith, Fox 26 News.
Feeding Rocks. It should not be a crime to feed the homeless. Feeding Rocks. A good Samaritan shouldn't be punished for acts of kindness. Feeding Rocks. Because it's more of a crime to turn your back on a starving person. Feeding Rocks. You shouldn't go to jail for sharing food. Feeding Rocks. Can't in good conscience let a hungry person starve. Feeding Rocks. Help us legalize charity. Go online and sign the petition. www.feeding.rocks. Feeding Rocks.
So what happened? happened is in 2012, the city of Houston made it criminal to give food to the homeless. And this is just, it's a crazy law. This has been going on in other cities. It's not just, it's all the major cities this has been going on. It's been going on in Florida. And in Florida, this elderly man has been put in jail for, oddly enough, feeding the homeless. It's just absolutely insane. I mean, you got to keep in mind that every type of religion, whether it's Christianity, whether it's Hinduism, whatever it is, it all has the basic idea that if someone's hungry, you should be able to give them food. And that's what, you know, this movement, these people are talking about is, you know, they just want to be able to give food to people that are hungry. So, you know, that's why I'm talking about this in this, this little video. You know, it's important to know whether you're in Houston, Texas, whether you're in another state. A lot of the major states and the major cities, there's a push to make it illegal to give food to the homeless. And it's just such a sad and mean-spirited law. And for example, there's a guy in Houston, his name is Jay Hamburger. And what he does is he boils eggs. And he gives boiled eggs to homeless. He's been doing it for years, for decades really. And the reason he does it is he just doesn't want these people to starve. It's humanitarian. It's not about being any type of, you know, Republican, Democrat, Libertarian. All it is about just not letting somebody starve. And it breaks my heart so much that, you know, this has become illegal. I mean, all these people want to do is just give food to somebody that's hungry. That's all they want to do. They don't want money for it. And the fact that the city has made it illegal, the city of Houston has made it a crime, a criminal act, to give food to the homeless, give food to someone hungry. And, you know, during Christmas, you know, it's illegal to do that. In fact, I have this case that I took where the city, what they did is this woman, she was giving food to homeless on Christmas Eve. They were starving. She wanted to give food to people, give them warm blankets. And in the grand scheme of things, yeah, it doesn't help much, but at least it helps that person that you see at the time. It kind of, it reminds me of the story, like the story of a starfish, where this boy is along the sea, and he's picking up these starfish, and he's just throwing them in. And someone's asking, why are you doing that? The reason he says he's doing it is because I'm helping this starfish right here. It might not matter to everybody else, but it matters to the starfish. You know, I'm talking about that because, like with my client, you know, where we're suing the city over, at least it mattered. The reason she gave food to those starving people on Christmas Eve is because it mattered to them. And in the grand scheme, yeah, it might not help everybody, but it helped the person then. And the whole thing that the city of Houston's pushing is this whole meaningful change, not spare change, but you need everything. And there's just not enough money to help all these starving people that exist. And some people don't even want to be helped. I mean, they want food, but not much more than that. They don't want to be rehabilitated. I mean, to be fair, our society is pretty crazy. And I can respect that they just don't want to, you know, take part in that. I can respect that. But I mean, I just don't see why they feel just the need to make it criminal to give somebody food. I mean, I can see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people money. I understand that. They might go spend it on drugs. Fine. I could see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people other things. And I guess I could say should be giving people, you know, stuff. But you should be able to give people clothing. And it's in the Bible, for crying out loud. It's a humanitarian act. It's not even anything. It's just sad. I can't believe why the current mayor and the previous mayor, they felt the need to make it a crime, to make it a criminal act to give food to the poor. I mean, the only way this is ever going to be changed is if really they're publicly shamed and that everybody knows that this law exists and everybody knows that, you know, the politicians don't want to change it. Whether they're Democrat, whether they're Republican, whether they're independent. And the whole reason they don't want to change it is how this law is really being used, is it's pushing out poor people from areas that they want to gentrify. And I'm not saying I'm against gentrification. I'm not saying I'm for it. I'm just saying they're using it kind of like starving out animals. That's probably how they see it, is starving out animals from different areas. And, downtown, there'll be a lot of, homeless people that'll be downtown because there's natural shelter with, buildings and bridges and what have you. And also there's, there's different organizations, different people that just go downtown and feed people, which they should be able to. So what I think what's going on is the city it's trying to push all these people, all these homeless people away from downtown, away from areas where developers are pouring, hundreds and millions of dollars, probably tens of millions of dollars into the pockets of politicians. And these are, Democrat politicians, Republican politicians, just any politician. They're, throwing money into their campaign contributions. They're filling up their tank, filling up their political, building their political capital. And in return, politicians are making it illegal to give food to the homeless. I really think that's the reason. There could be other reasons, maybe Star of Hope, maybe wherever those organizations are, that get federal funding, they get contributions that are contribution-based. They use their money, they use some of their money, they don't use all of it. In reality, it's kind of sad if you start looking at it. The majority of the money they get goes to their executives, and they're making like hundreds, $200,000, $300,000, $400,000 a year. And they're supposed to be out there actually helping people. So the city will make these laws to actually stop individuals from going out and giving food, while they're doing that, since they're hindering it, instead they'll encourage people just to donate to the Red Cross or all these different organizations, Star of Hope, which in all reality they just spend just pennies of the dollars that they collect in actually helping people. I think that's it's just wrong. It's morally wrong. If you're a Christian, it's all sorts of wrong. If you're just a human, it's wrong. It's bad, bad energy, bad spirited. And we can't let this type of law push. We can't let this type of law continue. It's so, so sad, especially during the holiday season. I mean, during Christmas, you want someone to get a $2,000 fine, a $2,000 fine for giving food to the homeless. That's what you could get in the city of Houston. Imagine that. If you're just at your house, you feel bad, so you go make a ham sandwich and you give it to the poor because you just feel bad, and you get tacked with a $2,000 fine. That's a lot of money. If you can't pay it, you go sit in jail for just giving someone food? Really? Oh my goodness. This is our country. I mean, this was a law that was pushed under Denise Parker in the city of Houston, who's supposed to be, a liberal progressive. And it's so mean. I just don't see how it's not a mean-spirited law. It's not just a bad energy law. When you're elected, you're supposed to be helping people. At least helping the least fortunate, the people this law could have killed people if you think about it. How many times has someone been hungry and hadn't been able to get something? I mean, in France, they're pushing these laws where it requires, instead of throwing your food away, you give it to the homeless. I think that's nice. I think Houston should explore these type of laws like that. But it's just inhumanitarian. I mean, what's the purpose behind a law that makes it a criminal act to give food? So what I'm asking you do is just retweet this, share it, what have you. Just let people know that these laws exist. The first thing is people got to realize that there's a problem. People don't realize there's a problem. They're too busy living their own lives, which, don't get me wrong, it's hard to live your own lives. If you have kids, I've got kids. They're exhausting. They beat me down all the time. If you're married, you got to deal with that. But just take a second and share. This video, share. Let people know that it's criminal, that it is a Class C misdemeanor You could go to jail if you don't pay a $2,000 fine. $2,000 for giving food to the homeless. That's just wrong. I think we all can agree with that. At the bare minimum, we all can agree with that. So please, retweet it, you know, share it, what have you. Post it on your social media. Let people know that it shouldn't be illegal to feed the homeless. And please help me gather, you know, signatures for the petition.
Feeding Rocks. It should not be a crime to feed the homeless. Feeding Rocks. A good Samaritan shouldn't be punished for acts of kindness. Feeding Rocks. Because it's more of a crime to turn your back on a starving person. Feeding Rocks. You shouldn't go to jail for sharing food. Feeding Rocks. Can't in good conscience let a hungry person starve. Feeding Rocks. Help us legalize charity. Go online and sign the petition. www.feeding.rocks. Feeding Rocks.
Breaking the law. One meal at a time, feeding the homeless.
It is morally wrong to make it a crime to give food.
A Houston man who feeds the homeless because of his faith is suing the city, challenging the established charitable feeding ban. The often debated ordinance has banned sharing food in public groups of more than five people without city permission since 2012.
The city says you can give food to five people, not six. What are you supposed to tell the sixth person? I met my quota today.
The city wants to dismiss Philip Paul Bryant's lawsuit.
That's a crime? What does this world come to? It's a sad day whenever trying to prevent a fellow human from starving is a crime.
The city says the ordinance aims to curb trespassing and littering, both of which were already prohibited in the municipal code prior to the passing of the ordinance. While some Houstonians are in support of the lawsuit,
I really hope he wins his case, and I really hope they lift those sanctions so we can be able to give more to the needy.
So if you're willing to help more than five homeless people, you should be able to do that.
Some even challenge the city's support of their citizens.
The city isn't going to take care of their homeless people. That's their people. Somebody got to take care of them. So why can't we take care of them?
A question Houstonians will continue to ask as long as the ban remains.
So what happened is in 2012, the city of Houston made it criminal to give food to the homeless. And this is just, it's a crazy law. This has been going on in other cities. It's not just, it's all the major cities this has been going on. It's been going on in Florida. And in Florida, this elderly man has been put in jail for, oddly enough, feeding the homeless. It's just absolutely insane. I mean, you got to keep in mind that every type of religion, whether it's Christianity, whether it's Hinduism, whatever it is, it all has the basic idea that if someone's hungry, you should be able to give them food. And that's what, you know, this movement, these people are talking about is, you know, they just want to be able to give food to people that are hungry. So, you know, that's why I'm talking about this in this little video. You know, it's important to know whether you're in Houston, Texas, whether you're in another state. A lot of the major states and the major cities, there's a push to make it illegal to give food to the homeless. And it's just such a sad and mean-spirited law. And for example, there's a guy in Houston, his name is Jay Hamburger, and what he does is he boils eggs. And he gives boiled eggs to homeless. He's been doing it for years, for decades, really. And the reason he does it is he just doesn't want these people to starve. It's just, it's humanitarian. It's not about being any type of, you know, Republican, Democrat, Libertarian. All it is about just not letting somebody starve. And it breaks my heart so much that, you know, this has become illegal. I mean, all these people want to do is just give food to somebody that's hungry. That's all they want to do. They don't want money for it. And the fact that the city has made it illegal, the city of Houston has made it a crime, a criminal act, to give food to the homeless, give food to someone hungry. And, you know, during Christmas, you know, it's illegal to do that. In fact, I have this case that I took where the city, what they did is this woman, she was giving food to homeless on Christmas Eve. They were starving. She wanted to give food to people, give them warm blankets. And in the grand scheme of things, yeah, it doesn't help much, but at least it helps that person that you see at the time. It kind of, it reminds me of the story, like the story of a starfish, where this boy is along the sea, and he's picking up these starfish, and he's just throwing them in. And someone's asking, why are you doing that? The reason he says he's doing it is because I'm helping this starfish right here. It might not matter to everybody else, but it matters to the starfish. You know, I'm talking about that because, like with my client, you know, where we're suing the city over, at least it mattered. The reason she gave food to those starving people on Christmas Eve is because it mattered to them. And in the grand scheme, yeah, it might not help everybody, but it helped the person then. And the whole thing that the city of Houston's pushing is this whole meaningful change, not spare change, but you need everything. And there's just not enough money to help all these starving people that exist. And some people don't even want to be helped. I mean, they want food, but not much more than that. They don't want to be rehabilitated. I mean, to be fair, our society is pretty crazy. And I can respect that they just don't want to, you know, take part in that. I can respect that. But I mean, I just don't see why they feel just the need to make it criminal to give somebody food. I mean, I can see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people money. I understand that. They might go spend it on drugs. Fine. I could see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people other things. And I guess I could say you shouldn't be giving people, you know, stuff. But you should be able to give people clothing. And it's in the Bible. We're crying out loud. It's a humanitarian act. It's not even anything. It's just sad. And I can't believe why the current mayor and the previous mayor, they felt the need to make it a crime, to make it a criminal act to give food to the poor. I mean, the only way this is ever going to be changed is if really they're publicly shamed and that everybody knows that this law exists and everybody knows that, you know, the politicians don't want to change it. Whether they're Democrat, whether they're Republican, whether they're independent. And the whole reason they don't want to change it is how this law is really being used, is it's pushing out you know, poor people from areas that they want to gentrify. And I'm not saying I'm against gentrification. I'm not saying I'm for it. I'm just saying they're using it kind of like starving out animals. That's probably how they see it, is starving out animals from different areas. And, you know, downtown, there'll be a lot of, you know, homeless people that'll be downtown because there's natural shelter with, you know, buildings and bridges and what have you. And also there's, you know, there's different organizations, different people that just go downtown and feed people, which they should be able to. So I think what's going on is the city doesn't want, it's trying to push all these people, all these homeless people away from downtown, away from areas where developers are pouring, you know, hundreds and millions of dollars, probably tens of millions of dollars into the pockets of politicians. And these are, you know, Democrat politicians, Republican politicians, just any politician. They're, you know, throwing money into their campaign contributions. They're filling up their tank, filling up their political, building their political capital. And in return, politicians are making it illegal to give food to the homeless. I really think that's the reason. There could be other reasons, maybe, you know, maybe Star of Hope, maybe wherever those organizations are, that get federal funding, they get contributions that are contribution-based. You know, they use their money, they use some of their money, they don't use all of it. In reality, it's kind of sad if you start looking at it. The majority of the money they get goes to their executives, and they're making like hundreds of $200,000-$400,000 a year. They're supposed to be out there actually helping people. So the city will make these laws to actually stop individuals from going out and giving food. But, you know, while they're doing that, since they're hindering it, Instead, they'll encourage people just to donate to, you know, the Red Cross or all these different organizations, Star of Hope, which in all reality, they just spend just pennies of the dollars that they collect in actually helping people. I think that's it's just wrong. It's morally wrong. If you're a Christian, it's all sorts of wrong. If you're just a human, it's wrong. It's bad energy, bad spirited. And we can't let this type of law push. We can't let this type of law continue. It's so sad, especially during the holiday season. I mean, during Christmas, you want someone to get a $2,000 fine. A $2,000 fine for giving food to the homeless. That's what you could get in the city of Houston. Imagine that. If you're just at your house, you feel bad, so you go make a ham sandwich and you give it to the poor because you just feel bad, and you get tacked with a $2,000 fine. That's a lot of money. If you can't pay it, you go sit in jail for just giving someone food? Really? Oh my goodness. This is our country. I mean, this was a law that was pushed under Denise Parker in the city of Houston, who's supposed to be, you know, a liberal progressive. And it's so mean. I just don't see how it's not a mean-spirited law. It's not just a bad energy law. You're trying to, when you're elected, you're supposed to be helping people. At least helping the least fortunate, the people that this law could have killed people if you think about it. How many times has someone been hungry and hadn't been able to get something? I mean, in France, they're pushing these laws where it requires, instead of throwing your food away, you give it to the homeless. I think that's nice. I think Houston should explore these type of laws like that. But it's just inhumanitarian. I mean, what's the purpose behind a law that makes it a criminal act to give food? So what I'm asking you do is just retweet this, you know, share it, what have you. Just let people know that these laws exist. The first thing is people got to realize that there's a problem. People don't realize there's a problem. They're too busy living their own lives, which, don't get me wrong, it's hard to live your own lives. If you have kids, I've got kids. They're exhausting. They beat me down all the time. If you're married, you know, you got to deal with that. But just take a second and share. You know, this video, share. Let people know that it's criminal, that it is a Class C misdemeanor. You could go to jail if you don't pay a $2,000 fine. $2,000 for giving food to the homeless. That's just wrong. I think we all can agree with that. At the bare minimum, we all can agree with that. So please, retweet it, you know, share it, what have you. Post it on your social media. Let people know that it shouldn't be illegal to feed the homeless. And please help me gather, you know, signatures for the petition.
A local pastor is fed up, and he's challenging the Houston Homeless Feeding Ordinance.
And the city requires you to get a permit if you are going to share food. He can't get a permit because he doesn't know where he's going to share food.
Philip Paul Bryan regularly keeps cans of tuna and water bottles in his car to hand out to homeless people. But under the current city ordinance, he's breaking the law. His attorney says Bryan does this because his faith teaches him to help the less fortunate.
This law that's in place, it's a mean-spirited law. It's against, you know, charity. It's against kindness. It's against doing the right thing.
Eric Dick says they plan to fight this till the mayor and city officials overturn what some believe is a misguided ordinance.
Feeding Rocks. It should not be a crime to feed the homeless. Feeding Rocks. A good Samaritan shouldn't be punished for acts of kindness. Feeding Rocks. Because it's more of a crime to turn your back on a starving person. Feeding Rocks. You shouldn't go to jail for sharing food. Feeding Rocks. Can't in good conscience let a hungry person starve. Feeding Rocks. Help us legalize charity. Go online and sign the petition. www.feeding.rocks. Feeding Rocks.
So what happened? happened is in 2012, the city of Houston made it criminal to give food to the homeless. This is just, it's a crazy law. This has been going on in other cities. It's not just, it's all the major cities this has been going on. It's been going on in Florida. And in Florida, this elderly man has been put in jail for, oddly enough, feeding the homeless. It's just absolutely insane. I mean, you got to keep in mind that every type of religion, whether it's Christianity, whether it's Hinduism, whatever it is, it all has the basic idea that if someone's hungry, you should be able to give them food. And that's what, you know, this movement, these people are talking about is, you know, they just want to be able to give food to people that are hungry. So, you know, that's why I'm talking about this in this, this little video. You know, it's important to know whether you're in Houston, Texas, whether you're in another state. A lot of the major states and the major cities, there's a push to make it illegal to give food to the homeless. And it's just such a sad and mean-spirited law. And for example, there's a guy in Houston, his name is Jay Hamburger. And what he does is he boils eggs, and he gives boiled eggs to homeless. He's been doing it for years, for decades really. And the reason he does it is he just doesn't want these people to starve. It's humanitarian. It's not about being any type of, you know, Republican, Democrat, Libertarian. All it is about just not letting somebody starve. And it breaks my heart so much that, you know, this has become illegal. I mean, all these people want to do is just give food to somebody that's hungry. That's all they want to do. They don't want money for it. And the fact that the city has made it illegal, the city of Houston has made it a crime, a criminal act, to give food to the homeless, give food to someone hungry. And, you know, during Christmas, you know, it's illegal to do that. In fact, I have this case that I took where the city, what they did is this woman, she was giving food to homeless on Christmas Eve. They were starving. She wanted to give food to people, give them warm blankets. And in the grand scheme of things, yeah, it doesn't help much, but at least it helps that person that you see at the time. It reminds me of the story, like the story of a starfish, where this boy is along the sea, and he's picking up these starfish, and he's just throwing them in. And someone's asking, why are you doing that? The reason he says he's doing it is because I'm helping this starfish right here. It might not matter to everybody else, but it matters to the starfish. You know, I'm talking about that because, like with my client, you know, where we're suing the city over, at least it mattered. The reason she gave food to those starving people on Christmas Eve is because it mattered to them. And in the grand scheme, yeah, it might not help everybody, but it helped the person then. And the whole thing that the city of Houston's pushing is this whole meaningful change, not spare change, but you need everything. And there's just not enough money to help all these starving people that exist. And some people don't even want to be helped. I mean, they want food, but not much more than that. They don't want to be rehabilitated. I mean, to be fair, our society is pretty crazy. And I can respect that they just don't want to, you know, take part in that. I can respect that. But I mean, I just don't see why they feel just the need to make it criminal to give somebody food. I mean, I can see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people money. I understand that. They might go spend it on drugs. Fine. I could see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people other things. And I guess I could say should be giving people, you know, stuff. But you should be able to give people clothing. And it's in the Bible, for crying out loud. It's a humanitarian act. It's not even anything. It's just sad. And I can't believe why the current mayor and the previous mayor, they felt the need to make it a crime, to make it a criminal act to give food to the poor. I mean, the only way this is ever going to be changed is if really they're publicly shamed and that everybody knows that this law exists and everybody knows that, you know, the politicians don't want to change it. Whether they're Democrat, whether they're Republican, whether they're independent. And the whole reason they don't want to change it is how this law is really being used, is it's pushing out poor people from areas that they want to gentrify. And I'm not saying I'm against gentrification. I'm not saying I'm for it. I'm just saying they're using it kind of like starving out animals. That's probably how they see it, is starving out animals from different areas. And, downtown, there'll be a lot of, homeless people that'll be downtown because there's natural shelter with, buildings and bridges and what have you. And also there's, there's different organizations, different people that just go downtown and feed people, which they should be able to. So I think what's going on is the city doesn't want, it's trying to push all these people, all these homeless people away from downtown, away from areas where developers are pouring, hundreds and millions of dollars, probably tens of millions of dollars into the pockets of politicians. And these are, Democrat politicians, Republican politicians, just any politician. They're, throwing money into their campaign contributions. They're filling up their tank, filling up their political, building their political capital. And in return, politicians are making it illegal to give food to the homeless. I really think that's the reason. There could be other reasons, maybe Star of Hope, maybe wherever those organizations are, that get federal funding, they get contributions that are contribution-based. They use their money, they use some of their money, they don't use all of it. In reality, it's kind of sad if you start looking at it. The majority of the money they get goes to their executives, and they're making like hundreds, $200,000, $300,000, $400,000 a year. And they're supposed to be out there actually helping people. So the city will make these laws to actually stop individuals from going out and giving food, while they're doing that, since they're hindering it, instead they'll encourage people just to donate to the Red Cross or all these different organizations, Star of Hope, which in all reality they just spend just pennies of the dollars that they collect in actually helping people. I think that's it's just wrong. It's morally wrong. If you're a Christian, it's all sorts of wrong. If you're just a human, it's wrong. It's bad energy, bad spirited. We can't let this type of law push. We can't let this type of law continue. It's so sad, especially during the holiday season. During Christmas, you want someone to get a $2,000 fine, a $2,000 fine for giving food to the homeless. That's what you could get in the city of Houston. Imagine that. If you're just at your house, you feel bad, so you go make a ham sandwich and you give it to the poor because you just feel bad, and you get tacked with a $2,000 fine. That's a lot of money. If you can't pay it, you go sit in jail for just giving someone food? Really? Oh my goodness. This is our country. This was a law that was pushed underneath Parker in the city of Houston, who's supposed to be, a liberal progressive. And it's so mean. I just don't see how it's not a mean-spirited law. It's not just a bad energy law. When you're elected, you're supposed to be helping people. At least helping the least fortunate, the people that this law could have killed people if you think about it. How many times has someone been hungry and they haven't been able to get something? In France, they're pushing these laws where it requires, instead of throwing your food away, you give it to the homeless. I think that's nice. I think Houston should explore these type of laws like that. But it's just inhumanitarian. What's the purpose behind a law that makes it a criminal act to give food? So what I'm asking you do is just retweet this, share it, what have you. Just let people know that these laws exist. The first thing is people got to realize that there's a problem. People don't realize there's a problem. They're too busy living their own lives, which, don't get me wrong, it's hard to live your own lives. If you have kids, I've got kids. They're exhausting. They beat me down all the time. If you're married, you got to deal with that. But just take a second and share. This video, share. Let people know that it's criminal, that it is a Class C misdemeanor. You could go to jail if you don't pay a $2,000 fine. $2,000 for giving food to the homeless. That's just wrong. I think we all can agree with that. At the bare minimum, we all can agree with that. So please, retweet it, share it, what have you. Post it on your social media. Let people know that it shouldn't be illegal to feed the homeless. And please help me gather, signatures for the petition.
Feeding Rocks. It should not be a crime to feed the homeless. Feeding Rocks. A good Samaritan shouldn't be punished for acts of kindness. Feeding Rocks. Because it's more of a crime to turn your back on a starving person. Feeding Rocks. You shouldn't go to jail for sharing food. Feeding Rocks. Can't in good conscience let a hungry person starve. Feeding Rocks. Help us legalize charity. Go online and sign the petition. www.feeding.rocks. Feeding Rocks.
A Houstonian claiming his religious freedom is being denied might soon see his lawsuit against the city dismissed.
And it appeared that Judge Kyle Carter was thinking about dismissing the case, saying that Philip doesn't have standing.
Philip Paul Bryant filed a lawsuit in 2017 claiming his religious rights to charitable giving were being infringed upon by a 2012 Houston Feeding the Homeless ordinance. In the city of Houston, you can give 5 homeless people a sandwich, but that 6th sandwich, that's the one that will cost you.
Could be fined $500 to $2,000, or you can even take the risk with going to jail.
According to his attorney, Eric Dick, Bryant's case may not find a home in Harris County Civil Court.
They're saying that my client, he waited over a year to file a lawsuit since he was found out about the law. If people just found out about the law, and they want to sue the city for this illegal act, I'm happy to represent them for free. I think that it's a mean world whenever acts of charity are criminal.
To be fair, the ordinance doesn't outright ban the giving of food to the homeless. It just creates a lot of hurdles to jump through to do it lawfully.
My children are a big deal in this, and teaching them how to give to the community. If they want to make 10 sack lunches and go hand them around downtown Houston, I shouldn't have to go to my government office in order to obtain permission just to give those sandwiches.
Is in 2012, the city of Houston made it criminal to give food to the homeless. This is just, it's a crazy law. This has been going on in other cities. It's not just, it's all the major cities this has been going on. It's been going on in Florida. And in Florida, this elderly man has been put in jail for, oddly enough, feeding the homeless. It's just absolutely insane. I mean, you got to keep in mind that every type of religion, whether it's Christianity, whether it's Hinduism, whatever it is, it all has the basic idea that if someone's hungry, you should be able to give them food. And that's what, this movement, these people are talking about is, they just want to be able to give food to people that are hungry. That's why I'm talking about this in this little video. It's important to know whether you're in Houston, Texas, whether you're in another state. A lot of the major states and the major cities, there's a push to make it illegal to give food to the homeless. And it's just such a sad and mean-spirited law. And for example, there's a guy in Houston, his name is Jay Hamburger. And what he does is he boils eggs. And he gives boiled eggs to homeless. He's been doing it for years, for decades, really. And the reason he does it is he just doesn't want these people to starve. It's humanitarian. It's not about being any type of, Republican, Democrat, Libertarian. All it is about just not letting somebody starve. And it breaks my heart so much that, this has become illegal. I mean, all these people want to do is just give food to somebody that's hungry. That's all they want to do. They don't want money for it. And the fact that the city has made it illegal, the city of Houston has made it a crime, a criminal act, to give food to the homeless, give food to someone hungry. And, you know, during Christmas, it's illegal to do that. In fact, I have this case that I took where the city, what they did is this woman, she was giving food to homeless on Christmas Eve. They were starving. She wanted to give food to people, give them warm blankets. And in the grand scheme of things, yeah, it doesn't help much, but at least it helps that person that you see at the time. It reminds me of the story, like the story of a starfish, where this boy is along the sea, and he's picking up these starfish, and he's just throwing them in. And someone's asking, why are you doing that? The reason he says he's doing it is because I'm helping this starfish right here. It might not matter to everybody else, but it matters to the starfish. I'm talking about that because, like with my client, where we're suing the city over, at least it mattered. The reason she gave food to those starving people on Christmas Eve is because it mattered to them. And in the grand scheme, yeah, it might not help everybody, but it helped the person then. And the whole thing that the city of Houston's pushing is this whole meaningful change, not spare change, but you need everything. And there's just not enough money to help all these starving people that exist. And some people don't even want to be helped. I mean, they want food, but not much more than that. They don't want to be rehabilitated. I mean, to be fair, our society is pretty crazy. And I can respect that they just don't want to, take part in that. I can respect that. But I just don't see why they feel just the need to make it criminal to give somebody food. I mean, I can see, you shouldn't be giving people money. I understand that. They might go spend it on drugs. Fine. I could see, you shouldn't be giving people other things. And I guess I could say shouldn't be giving people, stuff. But you should be able to give people clothing. And it's in the Bible, for crying out loud. It's a humanitarian act. It's not even anything. It's just sad. I can't believe why the current mayor and the previous mayor, they felt the need to make it a crime, to make it a criminal act to give food to the poor. The only way this is ever going to be changed is if really they're publicly shamed and that everybody knows that this law exists and everybody knows that, the politicians don't want to change it. Whether they're Democrat, whether they're Republican, whether they're independent. And the whole reason they don't want to change it is how this law is really being used, is it's pushing out poor people from areas that they want to gentrify. And I'm not saying I'm against gentrification. I'm not saying I'm for it. I'm just saying they're using it kind of like starving out animals. That's probably how they see it, is starving out animals from different areas. And, downtown, there'll be a lot of homeless people that'll be downtown because there's natural shelter with buildings and bridges and what have you, and also there's there's different organizations, different people that just go downtown and feed people, which they should be able to. So what I think what's going on is the city doesn't want, it's trying to push all these people, all these homeless people, away from downtown, away from areas where developers are pouring hundreds and millions of dollars, probably tens of millions of dollars into the pockets of politicians. And these are, Democrat politicians, Republican politicians, just any politician. They're, throwing money into their campaign contributions. They're filling up their tank, filling up their political, building their political capital. And in return, politicians are making it illegal to give food to the homeless. I really think that's the reason. There could be other reasons, maybe Star of Hope, maybe wherever those organizations are, that get federal funding, they get contributions that are contribution-based. They use their money, they use some of their money, they don't use all of it. In reality, it's kind of sad if you start looking at it. The majority of the money they get goes to their executives, and they're making like hundreds, $200,000, $300,000, $400,000 a year, They're supposed to be out there actually helping people. So the city will make these laws to actually stop individuals from going out and giving food. But you know, while they're doing that, since they're hindering it, instead they'll encourage people just to donate to, you know, the Red Cross or all these different organizations, Star of Hope, which in all reality they just spend just pennies of the dollars that they collect in actually helping people. I think that's it's just wrong. It's morally wrong. If you're a Christian, it's all sorts of wrong. If you're just a human, it's wrong. It's bad energy, bad spirited. And we can't let this type of law push. We can't let this type of law continue. It's so sad, especially during the holiday season. I mean, during Christmas, you want someone to get a $2,000 fine, a $2,000 fine for giving food to the homeless. That's what you could get in the city of Houston. Imagine that. If you're just at your house, you feel bad, so you go make a ham sandwich and you give it to the poor because you just feel bad, and you get tacked with a $2,000 fine. That's a lot of money. If you can't pay it, you go sit in jail for just giving someone food? Really? Oh my goodness. This is our country. I mean, this was a law that was pushed underneath Parker in the city of Houston, who's supposed to be, you know, a liberal progressive. And it's so mean. I just don't see how it's not a mean-spirited law. It's not just a bad energy law. When you're elected, you're supposed to be helping people. At least helping the least fortunate, the people that this law could have killed people if you think about it. How many times has someone been hungry and hadn't been able to get something? I mean, in France, they're pushing these laws where it requires, instead of throwing your food away, you give it to the homeless. I think that's nice. I think Houston should explore these type of laws like that. But it's just inhumanitarian. I mean, what's the purpose behind a law that makes it a criminal act to give food? So what I'm asking you do is just retweet this, you know, share it, what have you. Just let people know that these laws exist. The first thing is people got to realize that there's a problem. People don't realize there's a problem. They're too busy living their own lives, which, don't get me wrong, it's hard to live your own lives. If you have kids, I've got kids. They're exhausting. They beat me down all the time. If you're married, you know, you got to deal with that. But just take a second and share. You know, share this video, let people know that it's criminal, that it is a Class C misdemeanor. You could go to jail if you don't pay a $2,000 fine. $2,000 for giving food to the homeless. That's just wrong. I think we all can agree with that. At the bare minimum, we all can agree with that. So please, retweet it, you know, share it, what have you. Post it on your social media. Let people know that it shouldn't be illegal to feed the homeless. And please help me gather, you know, signatures for the petition.
A Houston man tonight is taking on the city of Houston. He is suing, saying he has the constitutional right to feed the homeless this Thanksgiving and any other day that he chooses.
Fox 26's Domalee Keith is live at Houston City Hall with more details on this. Domalee?
Yeah, you may remember the charitable feeding ban went into effect a few years ago, making it illegal to feed the homeless. Well, Philip Paul Bryant says it shouldn't be against the law to give food to someone in need. He says it should be the other way around, a crime not to give.
Of just trying to make sure a fellow human doesn't starve.
It sounds simple enough.
We aren't asking for anything else than to be able to give food to those that are less fortunate. Please let us do it.
Houston City Council members say they passed the charitable feeding ban to ensure homeless people receive food prepared under health code regulations, and so those in need will turn to an organization to eat, so they will receive other resources, services, and shelter as well.
Many of them take probably no more than 150 people. How many homeless are there? You cannot fit all the homeless into the shelters.
We pursued this lawsuit because we felt the city was trying to disinfringe not only on the less fortunate, but also trying to discourage good people, good Samaritans, from doing the right thing.
It's Thanksgiving. And it's the whole purpose of this holiday is to share food and eat. Let us practice our religion. Let us follow our faith. That's all we're asking.
Someone doesn't give them food, they won't have food to eat that night.
Brian says a number of groups wanting to set up outdoors and feed the homeless this Thanksgiving are discouraged for fear of being punished by the police.
There's going to be a lot of people who are on that border of saying, yeah, do we feed them, do we not feed them, do we want to go to jail, do we want to get a ticket?
Now, those who want to gather and feed the homeless have to first get permission from the city. And depending on where you plan to set up, you'll have to get permission from the property owner as well. There is a $500 fine for violating the ban, and you could go to jail if you don't pay that fine. We're live in downtown Houston. I'm Domalee Keith, Fox 26 News.
Feeding Rocks. It should not be a crime to feed the homeless. Feeding Rocks. Good Samaritans shouldn't be punished for acts of kindness. Feeding Rocks. Because it's more of a crime to turn your back on a starving person. Feeding Rocks. You shouldn't go to jail for sharing food. Feeding Rocks. Can't in good conscience let a hungry person starve. Feeding Rocks. Help us legalize charity. Go online and sign the petition. www.feeding.rocks. Feeding Rocks.
So what happened is in 2012, the city of Houston made it criminal to give food to the homeless. And this is just, it's a crazy law. This has been going on in other cities. It's not just, it's all the major cities this has been going on. It's been going on in Florida. And in Florida, this elderly man has been put in jail for, oddly enough, feeding the homeless. It's just absolutely insane. I mean, you got to keep in mind that every type of religion, whether it's Christianity, whether it's Hinduism, whatever it is, it all has the basic idea that if someone's hungry, you should be able to give them food. And that's what, you know, this movement, these people are talking about is, you know, they just want to be able to give food to people that are hungry. So, you know, that's why I'm talking about this in this little video. You know, it's important to know whether you're in Houston, Texas, whether you're in another state. A lot of the major states and the major cities, there's a push to make it illegal to give food to the homeless. And it's just such a sad and mean-spirited law. And for example, there's a guy in Houston, his name is Jay Hamburger, and what he does is he boils eggs. And he gives boiled eggs to homeless. He's been doing it for years, for decades, really. And the reason he does it is he just doesn't want these people to starve. It's humanitarian. It's not about being any type of, you know, Republican, Democrat, Libertarian. All it is about just not letting somebody starve. And it breaks my heart so much that, you know, this has become illegal. I mean, all these people want to do is just give food to somebody that's hungry. That's all they want to do. They don't want money for it. And the fact that the city has made it illegal, the city of Houston has made it a crime, a criminal act, to give food to the homeless, give food to someone hungry. And, you know, during Christmas, you know, it's illegal to do that. In fact, I have this case that I took where the city, what they did is this woman, she was giving food to homeless on Christmas Eve. They were starving. She wanted to give food to people, give them warm blankets. And in the grand scheme of things, yeah, it doesn't help much, but at least it helps that person that you see at the time. It reminds me of the story, like the story of a starfish, where this boy is along the sea, and he's picking up these starfish, and he's just throwing them in. And someone's asking, why are you doing that? The reason he says he's doing it is because I'm helping this starfish right here. It might not matter to everybody else, but it matters to the starfish. You know, I'm talking about that because, like with my client, you know, where we're suing the city over, at least it mattered. The reason she gave food to those starving people on Christmas Eve is because it mattered to them. And in the grand scheme, yeah, it might not help everybody, but it helped the person then. I mean, the whole thing that the city of Houston's pushing is this whole meaningful change, not spare change, but you need everything. And there's just not enough money to help all these starving people that exist. And some people don't even want to be helped. I mean, they want food, but not much more than that. They don't want to be rehabilitated. I mean, to be fair, our society is pretty crazy. And I can respect that they just don't want to, you know, take part in that. I can respect that. But I mean, I just don't see why they feel just the need to make it criminal to give somebody food. I mean, I can see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people money. I understand that. They might go spend it on drugs. Fine. I could see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people other things. And I guess I could say should be giving people, you know, stuff. But you should be able to give people clothing. And it's in the Bible, for crying out loud. It's a humanitarian act. It's not even anything. It's just sad. I can't believe why the current mayor and the previous mayor, they felt the need to make it a crime, to make it a criminal act to give food to the poor. I mean, the only way this is ever going to be changed is if really they're publicly shamed and that everybody knows that this law exists and everybody knows that, you know, the politicians don't want to change it. Whether they're Democrat, whether they're Republican, whether they're independent. And the whole reason they don't want to change it is how this law is really being used, is it's pushing out poor people from areas that they want to gentrify. And I'm not saying I'm against gentrification. I'm not saying I'm for it. I'm just saying they're using it kind of like starving out animals. That's probably how they see it, as starving out animals from different areas. And, you know, downtown, there'll be a lot of, you know, homeless people that'll be downtown because there's natural shelter with, you know, buildings and bridges and what have you. And also there's, there's different organizations, different people that just go downtown and feed people, which they should be able to. So what I think what's going on is the city doesn't want, it's trying to push all these people, all these homeless people away from downtown, away from areas where developers are pouring, you know, hundreds and millions of dollars, probably tens of millions of dollars into the pockets of politicians. And these are, you know, Democrat politicians, Republican politicians, just any politician. They're, you know, throwing money into their campaign contributions. They're filling up their tank, filling up their political, building their political capital. And in return, politicians are making it illegal to give food to the homeless. I really think that's the reason. There could be other reasons, maybe Star of Hope, maybe wherever those organizations are, that get federal funding, that get contributions that are contribution-based. They use their money, they use some of their money, they don't use all of it. In reality, it's kind of sad if you start looking at it. The majority of the money they get goes to their executives, and they're making like hundreds of $200,000-$400,000 a year, when they're supposed to be out there actually helping people. So the city will make these laws to actually stop individuals from going out and giving food. While they're doing that, since they're hindering it, instead they'll encourage people just to donate to, you know, the Red Cross or all these different organizations, Star of Hope, which in all reality they just spend just pennies of the dollars that they collect in actually helping people. I think that's just wrong. It's morally wrong. If you're a Christian, it's all sorts of wrong. If you're just a human, it's wrong. It's bad energy, bad spirited. And we can't let this type of law push. We can't let this type of law continue. It's so sad, especially during the holiday season. I mean, during Christmas, you want someone to get a $2,000 fine, $2,000 fine for giving food to the homeless. That's what you could get in the city of Houston. Imagine that. If you're just at your house, you feel bad, so you go make a ham sandwich and you give it to the poor because you just feel bad, and you get tacked with a $2,000 fine. That's a lot of money. If you can't pay it, you go sit in jail for just giving someone food? Really? Oh my goodness. This is our country. mean, this was a law that was pushed underneath Parker in the city of Houston, who's supposed to be, you know, a liberal progressive. And it's just, it's so mean. I just don't see how it's not a mean-spirited law. It's not just a bad energy law. You're trying to, when you're elected, you're supposed to be helping people, at least helping the least fortunate, the people that this law could have killed people. If you think about it, how many times has someone been hungry and hadn't been able to get something? I mean, in France, they're pushing these laws where it requires, instead of throwing your food away, you give it to the homeless. I think that's nice. I think Houston should explore these type of laws like that. But it's just inhumanitarian. I mean, what's the purpose behind a law that makes it a criminal act to give food? So what I'm asking you do is just retweet this, you know, share it, what have you. Just let people know that these laws exist. The first thing is people got to realize that there's a problem. People don't realize there's a problem. They're too busy living their own lives, which, don't get me wrong, it's hard to live your own lives. If you have kids, I've got kids. They're exhausting. They beat me down all the time. If you're married, you know, you got to deal with that. But just take a second and share. You know, this video, share. Let people know that it's criminal, that it is a Class C misdemeanor. You could go to jail if you don't pay a $2,000 fine. $2,000 for giving food to the homeless. That's just wrong. I think we all can agree with that. At the bare minimum, we all can agree with that. So please, retweet it, you know, share it, what have you. Post it on your social media. Let people know that it shouldn't be illegal to feed the homeless. And please help me gather, you know, signatures for the petition.
Breaking the law, one meal at a time, feeding the homeless.
It is morally wrong to make it a crime to give food.
A Houston man who feeds the homeless because of his faith is suing the city, challenging the established charitable feeding ban. The often debated ordinance has banned sharing food in public groups of more than five people without city permission since 2012.
The city says you can give food to five people, not six. What are you supposed to tell the sixth person? I met my quota today.
The city wants to dismiss Philip Paul Bryant's lawsuit.
That's a crime? What does this world come to? It's a sad day whenever trying to prevent a fellow human from starving is a crime.
The city says the ordinance aims to curb trespassing and littering, both of which were already prohibited in the municipal code prior to the passing of the ordinance. While some Houstonians are in support of the lawsuit,
I really hope he wins his case, and I really hope they lift those sanctions so we can be able to give more to the needy.
So if you're willing to help more than five homeless people, you should be able to do that.
Some even challenge the city's support of their citizens.
The city isn't going to take care of their homeless people. That's their people. Somebody got to take care of them. So why can't we take care of them?
A question Houstonians will continue to ask as long as the ban remains.
So what happened is in 2012, the city of Houston made it criminal to give food to the homeless. And this is just, it's a crazy law. This has been going on in other cities. It's not just, it's all the major cities this has been going on. It's been going on in Florida. And in Florida, this elderly man has been put in jail for, oddly enough, feeding the homeless. It's just absolutely insane. I mean, you got to keep in mind that every type of religion, whether it's Christianity, whether it's Hinduism, whatever it is, it all has the basic idea that if someone's hungry, you should be able to give them food. And that's what, you know, this movement, these people are talking about is, you know, they just want to be able to give food to people that are hungry. So, you know, that's why I'm talking about this in this little video. You know, it's important to know whether you're in Houston, Texas, whether you're in another state, a lot of the major states and the major cities, there's a push to make it illegal to give food to the homeless. And it's just such a sad and mean-spirited law. And for example, there's a guy in Houston, his name is Jay Hamburger. And what he does is he boils eggs, and he gives boiled eggs to homeless. He's been doing it for years, for decades really. And the reason he does it is he just doesn't want these people to starve. It's humanitarian. It's not about being any type of, you know, Republican, Democrat, Libertarian. All it is about just not letting somebody starve. And it breaks my heart so much that, you know, this has become illegal. I mean, all these people want to do is just give food to somebody that's hungry. That's all they want to do. They don't want money for it. And the fact that the city has made it illegal, the city of Houston has made it a crime, a criminal act, to give food to the homeless, give food to someone hungry. And, you know, during Christmas, it's illegal to do that. In fact, I have this case that I took where the city, what they did is this woman, she was giving food to homeless on Christmas Eve. They were starving. She wanted to give food to people, give them warm blankets. And in the grand scheme of things, yeah, it doesn't help much, but at least it helps that person that you see at the time. It reminds me of the story, like the story of a starfish, where this boy is along the sea, and he's picking up these starfish, and he's just throwing them in. And someone's asking, why are you doing that? The reason he says he's doing it is because I'm helping this starfish right here. It might not matter to everybody else, but it matters to the starfish. You know, I'm talking about that because, like with my client, you know, where we're suing the city over, at least it mattered. The reason she gave food to those starving people on Christmas Eve is because it mattered to them. And in the grand scheme, yeah, it might not help everybody, but it helped the person then. And the whole thing that the city of Houston's pushing is this whole meaningful change, not spare change, but you need everything. And there's just not enough money to help all these starving people that exist. And some people don't even want to be helped. I mean, they want food, but not much more than that. They don't want to be rehabilitated. I mean, to be fair, our society is pretty crazy. And I can respect that they just don't want to, you know, take part in that. I can respect that. But I mean, I just don't see why they feel just the need to make it criminal to give somebody food. I mean, I can see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people money. I understand that. They might go spend it on drugs. Fine. I could see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people other things. And I guess I could say should be giving people, you know, stuff. But you should be able to give people clothing. And it's in the Bible, for crying out loud. It's a humanitarian act. It's not even anything. It's just sad. I can't believe why the current mayor and the previous mayor, they felt the need to make it a crime, to make it a criminal act to give food to the poor. The only way this is ever going to be changed is if really they're publicly shamed and that everybody knows that this law exists and everybody knows that, you know, the politicians don't want to change it. Whether they're Democrat, whether they're Republican, whether they're independent. And the whole reason they don't want to change it is how this law is really being used, is it's pushing out poor people from areas that they want to gentrify. And I'm not saying I'm against gentrification. I'm not saying I'm for it. I'm just saying they're using it kind of like starving out animals. That's probably how they see it, is starving out animals from different areas. And, you know, downtown, there'll be a lot of, you know, homeless people that'll be downtown because there's natural shelter with, you know, buildings and bridges and what have you. And also there's, there's different organizations, different people that just go downtown and feed people, which they should be able to. So what I think what's going on is the city doesn't want, it's trying to push all these people, all these homeless people away from downtown, away from areas where developers are pouring, you know, hundreds and millions of dollars, probably tens of millions of dollars into the pockets of politicians. And these are, you know, Democrat politicians, Republican politicians, just any politician. they're you know throwing money into their campaign contributions. They're filling up their tank, filling up their political, building their political capital, and in return, politicians are making it illegal to give food to the homeless. I really think that's the reason. There could be other reasons, maybe Star of Hope, maybe wherever those organizations are, that get federal funding, they get contributions that are contribution-based. They use their money, they use some of their money, they don't use all of it. In reality, it's kind of sad if you start looking at it. The majority of the money they get goes to their executives, and they're making like hundreds, $200,000, $300,000, $400,000 a year. And they're supposed to be out there actually helping people. So the city will make these laws to actually stop individuals from going out and giving food. While they're doing that, since they're hindering it, instead they'll encourage people just to donate to the Red Cross or all these different organizations, Star of Hope, which in all reality they just spend just pennies of the dollars that they collect in actually helping people. I think that's it's just wrong. It's morally wrong. If you're a Christian, it's all sorts of wrong. If you're just a human, it's wrong. It's bad energy, bad spirited. We can't let this type of law push. We can't let this type of law continue. It's so sad, especially during the holiday season. I mean, during Christmas, you want someone to get a $2,000 fine, a $2,000 fine for giving food to the homeless. That's what you could get in the city of Houston. Imagine that. If you're just at your house, you feel bad, so you go make a ham sandwich and you give it to the poor because you just feel bad. And you get tacked with a $2,000 fine? That's a lot of money. If you can't pay it, you go sit in jail for just giving someone food? Really? Oh my goodness. This is our country. I mean, this was a law that was pushed under Denise Parker in the city of Houston, who's supposed to be, a liberal progressive. And it's so mean. I just don't see how it's not a mean-spirited law. It's not just a bad energy law. When you're elected, you're supposed to be helping people. At least helping the least fortunate, the people that this law could have killed people if you think about it. How many times has someone been hungry and hadn't been able to get something? I mean, in France, they're pushing these laws where it requires, instead of throwing your food away, you give it to the homeless. I think that's nice. I think Houston should explore these type of laws like that. But it's just inhumanitarian. I mean, what's the purpose behind a law that makes it a criminal act to give food? So what I'm asking you do is just retweet this, share it, what have you. Just let people know that these laws exist. The first thing is people got to realize that there's a problem. People don't realize there's a problem. They're too busy living their own lives, which, don't get me wrong, it's hard to live your own lives. If you have kids, I've got kids. They're exhausting. They beat me down all the time. If you're married, you got to deal with that. But just take a second and share. This video, share. Let people know that it's criminal, that it is a Class C misdemeanor. You could go to jail if you don't pay a $2,000 fine. $2,000 for giving food to the homeless. That's just wrong. I think we all can agree with that. At the bare minimum, we all can agree with that. So please, retweet it, share it, what have you. Post it on your social media. Let people know that it shouldn't be illegal to feed the homeless. And please help me gather, signatures for the petition.
A local pastor is fed up, and he's challenging the Houston Homeless Feeding Ordinance.
And the city requires you to get a permit if you are going to share food. He can't get a permit because he doesn't know where he's going to share food.
Philip Paul Bryan regularly keeps cans of tuna and water bottles in his car to hand out to homeless people. But under the current city ordinance, he's breaking the law. His attorney says Bryan does this because his faith teaches him to help the less fortunate.
This law that's in place, it's a mean-spirited law.
It's against, you know, charity. It's against kindness. It's against doing the right thing.
Eric Dick says they plan to fight this till the mayor and city officials overturn what some believe is a misguided ordinance.
So what happened is in 2012, the city of Houston made it criminal to give food to the homeless. This is just, it's a crazy law. This has been going on in other cities. It's not just, it's all the major cities this has been going on. It's been going on in Florida. And in Florida, this elderly man has been put in jail for, oddly enough, feeding the homeless. It's just absolutely insane. I mean, you got to keep in mind that every type of religion, whether it's Christianity, whether it's Hinduism, whatever it is, it all has the basic idea that if someone's hungry, you should be able to give them food. And that's what, you know, this movement, these people are talking about, is, you know, they just want to be able to give food to people that are hungry. So, you know, that's why I'm talking about this in this, this little video. You know, it's important to know whether you're in Houston, Texas, whether you're in another state. A lot of the major states and the major cities, there's a push to make it illegal to give food to the homeless. And it's just such a sad and mean-spirited law. And for example, there's a guy in Houston. His name is Jay Hamburger. And what he does is he boils eggs. And he gives boiled eggs to homeless. He's been doing it for years, for decades, really. And the reason he does it is he just doesn't want these people to starve. It's humanitarian. It's not about being any type of, you know, Republican, Democrat, Libertarian. All it is about just not letting somebody starve. And it breaks my heart so much that, you know, this has become illegal. I mean, all these people want to do is just give food to somebody that's hungry. That's all they want to do. They don't want money for it. And the fact that the city has made it illegal, the city of Houston has made it a crime, a criminal act, to give food to the homeless, give food to someone hungry. And, you know, during Christmas, you know, it's illegal to do that. In fact, I have this case that I took where the city, what they did is this woman, she was giving food to homeless on Christmas Eve. They were starving. She wanted to give food to people, give them warm blankets. And in the grand scheme of things, yeah, it doesn't help much, but at least it helps that person that you see at the time. It kind of, it reminds me of the story, like the story of a starfish, where this boy is along the sea, and he's picking up these starfish, and he's just throwing them in. And someone's asking, why are you doing that? The reason he says he's doing it, it's because I'm helping this starfish right here. It might not matter to everybody else, but it matters to the starfish. You know, I'm talking about that because, like with my client, you know, where we're suing the city over, at least it mattered. The reason she gave food to those starving people on Christmas Eve is because it mattered to them. And in the grand scheme, yeah, it might not help everybody, but it helped the person then. And the whole thing that the city of Houston is pushing is this whole meaningful change, not spare change, but you need everything. And there's just not enough money to help all these starving people that exist. And some people don't even want to be helped. I mean, they want food, but not much more than that. They don't want to be rehabilitated. I mean, to be fair, our society is pretty crazy. And I can respect that they just don't want to, you know, take part in that. I can respect that. But I mean, I just don't see why they feel just the need to make it criminal to give somebody food. I mean, I can see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people money. I understand that. They might go spend it on drugs. Fine. I could see, you know, you shouldn't be giving people other things. And I guess I could say shouldn't be giving people, you know, stuff. But you should be able to give people clothing. And it's in the Bible. We're crying out loud. It's just, it's a humanitarian act. It's not even anything. It's just sad. And I can't believe why the current mayor and the previous mayor, they felt the need to make it a crime, to make it a criminal act to give food to the poor. The only way this is ever going to be changed is if really they're publicly shamed and that everybody knows that this law exists and everybody knows that, you know, the politicians don't want to change it, whether they're Democrat, whether they're Republican, whether they're independent. And the whole reason they don't want to change it is how this law is really being used is it's pushing out, poor people from areas that they want to gentrify. And I'm not saying I'm against gentrification. I'm not saying I'm for it. I'm just saying they're using it kind of like starving out animals. That's probably how they see it, is starving out animals from different areas. And, you know, downtown, there'll be a lot of, you know, homeless people that'll be downtown because there's natural shelter with, you know, buildings and bridges and what have you. And also there's, there's different organizations, different people that just go downtown and feed people, which they should be able to. So I think what's going on is the city it's trying to push all these people, all these homeless people away from downtown, away from areas where developers are pouring, you know, hundreds and millions of dollars, probably tens of millions of dollars into the pockets of politicians. And these are, you know, Democrat politicians, Republican politicians, just any politician. They're, you know, throwing money into their campaign contributions. They're filling up their tank, filling up their political, building their political capital. And in return, politicians are making it illegal to give food to the homeless. I really think that's the reason. There could be other reasons, maybe Star of Hope, maybe wherever those organizations are, that get federal funding, they get contributions that are contribution-based. They use their money, they use some of their money, they don't use all of it. In reality, it's kind of sad if you start looking at it. The majority of the money they get goes to their executives, and they're making like hundreds, $200,000-$400,000 a year. And they're supposed to be out there actually helping people. So the city will make these laws to actually stop individuals from going out and giving food. While they're doing that, since they're hindering it, instead they'll encourage people just to donate to, you know, the Red Cross or all these different organizations, Star of Hope, which in all reality they just spend just pennies of the dollars that they collect in actually helping people. I think that's it's just wrong. It's morally wrong. If you're a Christian, it's all sorts of wrong. If you're just a human, it's wrong. It's bad energy, bad spirited. We can't let this type of law push. We can't let this type of law continue. It's so sad, especially during the holiday season. During Christmas, you want someone to get a $2,000 fine, a $2,000 fine for giving food to the homeless. That's what you could get in the city of Houston. Imagine that. If you're just at your house, you feel bad, so you go make a ham sandwich and you give it to the poor because you just feel bad, and you get tacked with a $2,000 fine. That's a lot of money. If you can't pay it, you go sit in jail for just giving someone food? Really? Oh my goodness. This is our country. This was a law that was pushed underneath Parker in the city of Houston, who's supposed to be, you know, a liberal progressive. And it's so mean. I just don't see how it's not a mean-spirited law. It's not just a bad energy law. When you're elected, you're supposed to be helping people. At least helping the least fortunate, the people this law could have killed people if you think about it. How many times has someone been hungry and they haven't been able to get something? In France, they're pushing these laws where it requires, instead of throwing your food away, you give it to the homeless. I think that's nice. I think Houston should explore these type of laws like that. But it's just inhumanitarian. What's the purpose behind a law that makes it a criminal act to give food? So what I'm asking you do is just retweet this, share it, what have you. Just let people know that these laws exist. The first thing is people got to realize that there's a problem. People don't realize there's a problem. They're too busy living their own lives, which, don't get me wrong, it's hard to live your own lives. If you have kids, I've got kids. They're exhausting. They beat me down all the time. If you're married, you know, you got to deal with that. But just take a second and share. You know, this video, share. Let people know that it's criminal, that it is a Class C misdemeanor. You could go to jail if you don't pay a $2,000 fine. $2,000 for giving food to the homeless. That's just wrong. I think we all can agree with that. At the bare minimum, we all can agree with that. So please, retweet it, you know, share it, what have you. Post it on your social media. Let people know that it shouldn't be illegal to feed the homeless. And please help me gather, you know, signatures for the petition.
A Houstonian claiming his religious freedom is being denied might soon see his lawsuit against the city dismissed.
And it appeared that Judge Kyle Carter was thinking about dismissing the case, saying that Philip doesn't have standing.
Philip Paul Bryant filed a lawsuit in 2017 claiming his religious rights to charitable giving were being infringed upon by a 2012 Houston Feeding the Homeless ordinance. In the city of Houston, you can give five homeless people a sandwich, but that sixth sandwich, that's the one that will cost you.
Could be fined $500 to $2,000, or you can even take the risk with going to jail.
According to his attorney, Eric Dick, Bryant's case may not find a home in Harris County Civil Court.
They're saying that my client, he waited over a year to file a lawsuit since he found out about the law. If people just found out about the law, and they want to sue the city for this illegal act, I'm happy to represent them for free. I think that it's a mean world whenever acts of charity are criminal.
To be fair, the ordinance doesn't outright ban the giving of food to the homeless. It just creates a lot of hurdles to jump through to do it lawfully.
My children are a big deal in this, and teaching them how to give to the community. If they want to make 10 sack lunches and go hand them around downtown Houston, I shouldn't have to go to my government office in order to obtain permission just to give those sandwiches.
Is in 2012, the city of Houston made it criminal to give food to the homeless. This is just, it's a crazy law. This has been going on in other cities. It's not just, it's all the major cities this has been going on. It's been going on in Florida. And in Florida, this elderly man has been put in jail for, oddly enough, feeding the homeless. It's just absolutely insane. I mean, you got to keep in mind that every type of religion, whether it's Christianity, whether it's Hinduism, whatever it is, it all has the basic idea that if someone's hungry, you should be able to give them food. And that's what, you know, this movement, these people are talking about is, you know, they just want to be able to give food to people that are hungry. So, you know, that's why I'm talking about this in this little video. You know, it's important to know whether you're in Houston, Texas, whether you're in another state. A lot of the major states and the major cities, there's a push to make it illegal to give food to the homeless. And it's just such a sad and mean-spirited law. And for example, there's a guy in Houston, his name is Jay Hamburger. And what he does is he boils eggs. And he gives boiled eggs to homeless. He's been doing it for years, for decades, really. And the reason he does it is he just doesn't want these people to starve. It's humanitarian. It's not about being any type of, you know, Republican, Democrat, Libertarian. All it is about just not letting somebody starve. And it breaks my heart so much that, you know, this has become illegal. I mean, all these people want to do is just give food to somebody that's hungry. That's all they want to do. They don't want money for it. And the fact that the city has made it illegal, the city of Houston has made it a crime, a criminal act, to give food to the homeless, give food to someone hungry. And, you know, during Christmas, it's illegal to do that. In fact, I have this case that I took where the city, what they did is this woman, she was giving food to homeless on Christmas Eve. They were starving. She wanted to give food to people, give them warm blankets. And in the grand scheme of things, yeah, it doesn't help much, but at least it helps that person that you see at the time. It reminds me of the story, like the story of a starfish, where this boy is along the sea, and he's picking up these starfish, and he's just throwing them in. And someone's asking, why are you doing that? The reason he says he's doing it is because I'm helping this starfish right here. It might not matter to everybody else, but it matters to the starfish. I'm talking about that because, like with my client, where we're suing the city over, at least it mattered. The reason she gave food to those starving people on Christmas Eve is because it mattered to them. And in the grand scheme, yeah, it might not help everybody, but it helped the person then. And the whole thing that the city of Houston's pushing is this whole meaningful change, not spare change, but you need everything. And there's just not enough money to help all these starving people that exist. And some people don't even want to be helped. I mean, they want food, but not much more than that. They don't want to be rehabilitated. I mean, to be fair, our society is pretty crazy. And I can respect that they just don't want to, take part in that. I can respect that. But I just don't see why they feel just the need to make it criminal to give somebody food. I mean, I can see, you shouldn't be giving people money. I understand that. They might go spend it on drugs. Fine. I could see, you shouldn't be giving people other things. And I guess I could say shouldn't be giving people, stuff. But you should be able to give people clothing. It's in the Bible, for crying out loud. It's a humanitarian act. It's not even anything. It's just sad. I can't believe why the current mayor and the previous mayor, they felt the need to make it a crime, to make it a criminal act to give food to the poor. The only way this is ever going to be changed is if really they're publicly shamed and that everybody knows that this law exists and everybody knows that, the politicians don't want to change it. Whether they're Democrat, whether they're Republican, whether they're independent. And the whole reason they don't want to change it is how this law is really being used, is it's pushing out poor people from areas that they want to gentrify. And I'm not saying I'm against gentrification. I'm not saying I'm for it. I'm just saying they're using it kind of like starving out animals. That's probably how they see it, as starving out animals from different areas. And, downtown, there'll be a lot of, homeless people that'll be downtown because there's natural shelter with, buildings and bridges and what have you. And also there's, there's different organizations, different people that just go downtown and feed people, which they should be able to. So what I think what's going on is the city doesn't want, it's trying to push all these people, all these homeless people away from downtown, away from areas where developers are pouring hundreds and millions of dollars, probably tens of millions of dollars into the pockets of politicians. And these are, Democrat politicians, Republican politicians, just any politician. They're, throwing money into their campaign contributions. They're filling up their tank, filling up their political, building their political capital. And in return, politicians are making it illegal to give food to the homeless. I really think that's the reason. There could be other reasons, maybe Star of Hope, maybe wherever those organizations are, that get federal funding, they get contributions that are contribution-based. They use their money, they use some of their money, they don't use all of it. In reality, it's kind of sad if you start looking at it. The majority of the money they get goes to their executives, and they're making like hundreds, $200,000, $300,000, $400,000 a year. They're supposed to be out there actually helping people. So the city will make these laws to actually stop individuals from going out and giving food. But you know, while they're doing that, since they're hindering it, instead they'll encourage people just to donate to, you know, the Red Cross or all these different organizations, Star of Hope, which in all reality they just spend just pennies of the dollars that they collect in actually helping people. I think that's it's just wrong. It's morally wrong. If you're a Christian, it's all sorts of wrong. If you're just a human, it's wrong. It's bad energy, bad spirited. And we can't let this type of law push. We can't let this type of law continue. It's so sad, especially during the holiday season. I mean, during Christmas, you want someone to get a $2,000 fine. A $2,000 fine for giving food to the homeless. That's what you could get in the city of Houston. Imagine that. If you're just at your house, you feel bad, so you go make a ham sandwich and you give it to the poor because you just feel bad, and you get tacked with a $2,000 fine. That's a lot of money. If you can't pay it, you go sit in jail for just giving someone food? Really? Oh my goodness. This is our country. I mean, this was a law that was pushed under Denise Parker in the city of Houston, who's supposed to be, you know, a liberal progressive. And it's so mean. I just don't see how it's not a mean-spirited law. It's not just a bad energy law. And when you're elected, you're supposed to be helping people. At least helping the least fortunate, the people that this law could have killed people if you think about it. How many times has someone been hungry and hadn't been able to get something? I mean, in France, they're pushing these laws where it requires, instead of throwing your food away, you give it to the homeless. I think that's nice. I think Houston should explore these type of laws like that. But it's just inhumanitarian. I mean, what's the purpose behind a law that makes it a criminal act to give food? So what I'm asking you do is just retweet this, you know, share it, what have you. Just let people know that these laws exist. The first thing is people got to realize that there's a problem. People don't realize there's a problem. They're too busy living their own lives, which, don't get me wrong, it's hard to live your own lives. If you have kids, I've got kids. They're exhausting. They beat me down all the time. If you're married, you know, you got to deal with that. But just take a second and share. You know, this video, share. Let people know that it's criminal, that it is a Class C misdemeanor. You could go to jail if you don't pay a $2,000 fine. $2,000 for giving food to the homeless. That's just wrong. I think we all can agree with that. At the bare minimum, we all can agree with that. So please, retweet it, you know, share it, what have you. Post it on your social media. Let people know that it shouldn't be illegal to feed the homeless. And please help me gather, you know, signatures for the petition.